The following is a special presentation from the WTNS Sports Department.
It's time now for high school football from FM 99.3 WTNS. Coming up next, it's Coach's Corner with Steve Corries on the sports voice of East Central Ohio, FM 99.3 WTNS.
Recycling, located at the intersection of County Road 1A and Bridge Street, has been family-owned and operated since 1985, making them the oldest scrapyard in Coshocton County still in operation. Coshocton Recycling accepts all types of scrap metal, including vehicles. If you're looking to recycle your scrap metal the easy way with the best prices, stop by Coshocton Recycling. They are open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 4:15, or give them a call at 740-622-6276.
If you own a farm, you know that a one-size-fits-all insurance policy isn't a smart way to do business. I'm John Iannello, your American National Insurance Agent in Coshocton, Holmes, and surrounding counties. American National can provide you with a flexible farm package that allows you to customize a policy to match your individual needs. Call me at 740-295-9460. Because while you know your business, we know how to help insure it.
The Fisher Funeral Home in Warsaw is proud to sponsor this event as we support the families and individuals that have trusted us with their business through our four generations of service to the community. As the oldest family-owned and operated funeral home in Coshocton County, we understand the importance of supporting our youth and fostering pride in our community. Please call us anytime at 740-824-3515. For any of your pre-need or at-need funeral counseling needs. You can also visit our website at fisherfuneralhome.com. The Fisher Funeral Home, serving others as we would like to be served since 1937.
Main Street Station in Coshocton offers family-friendly dining, great food, and competitive prices. Stop by Main Street Station for weekly specials like Wing Night on Tuesdays, the famous shrimp tacos on Wednesdays, and different weekend specials. Try their artisan grilled cheese and their mainline grilled cheese, the first with a Maryland-style crab cake, the second with lightly seasoned lobster, both grilled with provolone cheese on freshly baked Italian bread. Main Street Station is open for lunch and dinner Tuesday through Saturday. Advanced Spinal Care and Rehabilitation of Coshocton provides personalized health care that makes a difference. If you've been suffering from neck or back pain, chiropractic care is a non-invasive treatment that can help you feel better. Advanced Spinal Care and Rehabilitation is proud to provide patients with advanced physical medicine. This type of rehabilitation is focused on enhancing and restoring the functional abilities of those suffering from physical impairments. To schedule your appointment, call Advanced Spinal Care and Rehabilitation at 291-8100 or stop by 112 Chestnut Street in Coshocton. Keep your vehicle on the road with new tires or mechanical work from Shriver Tire Service. Shriver Tire offers new tires for passenger, truck, and farm vehicles, as well as light mechanical work. Custom wheels are now available, as well as financing. Shriver Tire is now an authorized dealer for Falcon Tires. For more information, stop by 2171 Otsego Avenue or give them a call at 622-6989.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by the Ensley Insurance Agency. For auto, home, business, and life insurance, call 740-622-1111. That's the Ensley Insurance Agency, 433 Walnut Street, Coshocton.
The Ensley Agency is proud to be a part of this high school sports broadcast. We support the student athletes on the team and the students in all extracurricular activities. Hi, I'm Todd Ensley. In fact, your good student may qualify for discounted auto insurance rates. We can provide you with homeowners insurance and life insurance from Auto Owners Insurance. Insure both with us and save even more. For a no-obligation quote on auto, homeowners, or life insurance from Auto Owners Insurance, call the Ensley Agency at 622-1111.
Guest on Coach's Corner, John Slusser, the head coach of the Ridgewood Generals. Generals come in tonight with a record of 3-1 on the campaign. Don't want to get into it a whole lot, but just kind of a brief synopsis on what happened last Friday night against a really good West Branch team.
You know what? We couldn't handle them offensively. You know, they were able to score every time they had the ball, except for one or two, I think. And, you know, they made plays. We gave ourselves some opportunity, but weren't able to get off the field on third down. And it was a game hopefully we learned from and you know, we're able to build on it. It was obviously it was a tough task. I think they're one of the top two or three teams in Division IV in the state of Ohio. And it was a tough night, but hopefully we put that away and we're ready to go tonight.
All right. We're through week four, the preseason, I guess, the best way to term it. When you look at your football team 4 weeks in, any surprises, positive or negatively?
You know what? Not really. You know, I thought coming into the year we were pretty good up front, especially defensively. And even offensively, I thought we'd be pretty good. And we have been for the most part. Our skill has not been great, but we knew that coming in. But to their credit, I think we've gotten better at it. We've found some pieces that have come on pretty good for us. We've done a pretty good job blocking on the edge. So, you know, that part's been okay, but we knew we were limited out there a little bit, especially when you lose the skill athletes we lost last year. But, you know, overall, I said this, it's still been a really good Ridgewood team. I think our kids play extremely hard. I think we take great pride in our work, and so far it's been a pleasure to coach them.
All right. Now this week, well, you've got Malvern, team that comes in here undefeated, 4-0. What can you tell us about those people?
You know, Malvern, it's always been a big game for us. You know, it's kind of drifted away since they went to the two divisions, but this year we have them back in a crossover. I believe it's the first time we've played them in a while. I don't know the exact time, but it's been a while. They're a little bit of a young team, but they are undefeated. They have a really good quarterback. He's, you know, one of the best athletes on the field tonight. Have a nice receiver. They're going to test us by throwing it around and pushing us on the perimeter. So, you know, it's a game that scares me because they're so skilled at those spots, and that's the spot we're not great at. So we're going to have to play really well tonight and be ready for everything.
All right. Now let's talk about keys. What do you need to do to get a victory here tonight?
Well, obviously, we've got to control the trenches on both sides. I need my defensive line to dominate the football game, you know, which I think they can do by getting pressure on that kid and stopping the running game. That's a big deal to us. We've been really blessed. Colin Smith's had a really great year, a linebacker. We need that to continue tonight. The past few games, he's been phenomenal. You know, I hope he can keep it going. I told him we really need him another week this week. And we got to limit their big plays. We can't let them drop back and hit 30 and 40-yard plays. You know, like last week, we couldn't get off the field on third down. We've got to be able to do that tonight.
All right. The other question, I guess the last question, would be health of the ball club. You told me off the air that you were a little dinged up. What can you tell us?
Well, I mean, we're battled sickness up here in West Lafayette this week, so we've had some kids out with sickness. One of our guys hasn't been at practice all week, so that's Cam Stanton. I don't know how well he'll be tonight and what role he'll have, but hopefully he's feeling good and better. Joe got a little dinged up last week. I expect him to play tonight. You know, what role, I'm not sure, but we expect him to be on the field. So I guess we're healthy. We just battled the sickness bug a little bit this week. And, you know, anytime you do that and guys are out of practice, it's not a good thing. So no excuses. We got to be ready to go here. And this is a big game for us. If we want to get where we want to go, this is a game we got to have.
All right. That's head coach John Slusser. Good luck here tonight.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right. We'll be back with the pregame. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Coach's Corner has been brought to you by the Endley Insurance Agency, 433 Walnut Street in Coshocton. Call the Endley Insurance Agency at 740-622-1111 or go to endleyagency.com.
Get your vehicle back on the road smooth and problem-free with Village Motors Collision Center. Hi, this is Deke Miller, and our Collision Center works on all makes and models and has available deductible assistance, along with loaner and rental vehicles available for your use, complimentary oil change packages, not to mention that we are the preferred repair shop for most insurance companies. Ask us about our cleanup packages with four great packages from basic to premium by appointment only starting at $19.95. For collision repair, make your first stop at Village Motors in Millersburg.
Life is full of uncertainties. What happens to your assets after you pass away shouldn't be one of them. At Raymond James Financial Services, we offer a transfer on death agreement that allows your estate to be held in a brokerage account, so it avoids the probate process and goes directly to your heirs. To find out how to make things easier for your loved ones, call financial advisor Shane Pyle at 622-3110, located in Coshocton. Raymond James Financial Services, member FINRA SIPC. Life well planned.
There's always time for the drive-thru deal. Because no matter how fast you are at making breakfast, McDonald's is faster.
Pumpkin Spice is back for a limited time only. Now you can get any size iced coffee for just $2. Try flavors like French Vanilla, sugar-free French Vanilla, caramel, and Pumpkin Spice for a limited time, only $2.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal.
Lifestyle Home Furnishings in the Downtowner Plaza is your hometown furniture, mattress, and appliance store. Featuring everyday low prices, flexible payment plans, and our Lifestyle Smart Lease with 120 days same as cash, Lifestyle makes it easy and affordable to get the home furnishings you're looking for. Stop by or give us a call. Find us on Facebook or shop online at shoplifestylenow.com.
Lifestyle Home Furnishings, your life, your style, your home.
It's time to be thinking about those concrete projects. Coshocton Materials offers ready-mix concrete, precast blocks, and a variety of mason and concrete products. Located on County Road 621 in Coshocton, call today for prices and delivery options at 740-722-9015. That's 740-722-9015.
Appearance Supply, Glass and Paint, your window tinting specialist for Johnson's Window Tinting for residential and vehicles. Johnson's Window Tints are designed for style, protection, and heat reduction, and they have a lifetime warranty. Remember, Appearance Supply, Glass and Paint for auto glass, including windshields, residential, and commercial glass. They also stock PPG Automotive Paint and Supplies. That's Appearance Supply, Glass and Paint, 115 Bridge Street, Coshocton. Appearance Supply is proud to sponsor the Woodworker of the Week, a weekly award given to the hardest working Ridgewood General football player.
Ridgewood, before we preview that game, let's take a look around at other games in our area. Coshocton 0-4 travels to Morgan 3-1. Coshocton, plain and simple, have not been able to score any points. Penalties and a lot of youth have been really the big factors for them. Tonight they play a Morgan team that is big and talented up front. They will try to move the ball on the ground and wear out the Redskins. Offensively, Coshocton will try to move the ball on the ground and pick their spots to throw the ball. Morgan looks a little too strong on paper, but this should be a good one down at Morgan. Riverview 2-2 as home for homecoming with Meadowbrook. As mentioned, it's homecoming at Riverview, and the Bears are looking to make it 3 in a row. Riverview has found a formula with their wing T offense. They will attack you inside with Cruz Mobley, and Jamal Watts has speed and power on the outside. The defense continues to improve. Meadowbrook graduated a strong class and is trying to regain their footing. Look for the Bears to go over the 500 mark with a win at homecoming tonight. Tri-Valley 3-1 at New Lexington 4-0. And normally this wouldn't be much of a matchup, but New Lexington is an interesting game for sure. This game will probably be determined on how well Tri-Valley can contain the explosive New Lexington offense. Look for Tri-Valley to eke out a close one down at New Lex. Our feature game has unbeaten Malvern 4-0 coming to West Lafayette to meet the 3-1 Ridgewood Generals. Malvern is led by sophomore quarterback Jared Withrow. The Hornets have been able to score points and have hit the big play in the passing game. Ridgewood will rely on their ball control offense and a stout defense to be successful. Ridgewood is looking to bounce back from a tough loss last week at West Branch. Go with the Generals to get it done in this IVC crossover game. Taking a look at other games in our area, first let's take a look at the IVC. Strasburg 0-4 is at Garaway 4-0. Buckeye Trail 0-4 is at Claymont 1-3. TCC 2-0 is at Tuskegee Valley 0-4. Newcomerstown 3-1 goes to Indian Valley, who's 2-2. East Canton is 1-3, and they'll play Sandy Valley 2-2. In the MVL tonight, we've already mentioned Coshocton's at Morgan. Crooksville 0-4 goes to Maysville, who's 2-2. West Muskingum 3-1 is at Philo 1-3. Mentioned also Meadowbrook's at Riverview. Sheridan 3-1 goes to John Glenn 1-3. And as mentioned also, Tri-Valley 3-1 at New Lexington, who is unbeaten at 4-0. We'll be back and get to the national anthem in a moment. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Buckeye Beverage Barn in West Lafayette has carryout salads, pizza, calzones, and their new wings. Place your orders at 545-9525. Buckeye Beverage Barn has the area's best selection of cold drinks and hot food with all the convenience of their drive-thru. See them for snacks, bagged ice, salads, and delicious pizza. Order yours tonight at 545-9525. Drive through and see them 7 days a week at the Buckeye Beverage Barn on Main Street in West Lafayette.
In the nation, we know how it feels when a company doesn't treat you like a priority. You feel small. Or worst of all, like you're just a voice in a crowd. At Nationwide, we put members first. Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
To join the nation, call Scott Boyer in Coshocton today at 740-622-2131.
Subject to underwriting guidelines, review, and approval. Availability and details vary. Nationwide Mutual Insurance Company and Affiliates, Columbus, Ohio.
If you're a business or do-it-yourselfer looking for the best possible siding for your home or office, then stop by MRV Siding Supply. They offer the number one rated panel on the market, Cedar Max Super Polymer Insulated Siding by Provia. Cedar Max provides outstanding performance inside and out with impact resistance, impervious to moisture, flame retardant, and noise reduction, giving you peace of mind. For Cedar Max Super Polymer Insulated Siding by Provia, call MRV Siding Supply at 800-524-7436. Visit them on the web at mrvsiding.com.
Wayne Ductal is proud to be part of the Coshocton community since 1910. If you'd like to work for one of Coshocton's top employers, they'd like to talk with you. McWayne Ductal will be holding open interviews for production entry-level positions on Tuesday, August 2nd at their factory location at 2266 South 6th Street. Interviews will be from 9 a.m. to noon. Prospective employees are asked to sign in at the guardhouse. Again, open interviews for entry-level production positions will be held on Tuesday, August 2nd from 9 a.m. to noon at the factory location on South 6th Street. McWayne Ductal is an equal opportunity employer.
You need a new or newer vehicle? Hi, I'm Jeff Drennan, and we are here to help in both sales and service. At my dealerships in Coshocton and Zanesville, we work hard to get you the best car deal possible, including during the current conditions in the car industry. Or if you want to sell your vehicle and it has under 100,000 miles, just stop in and see us and let us make you an offer. Stop in today at Jeff Drennan's Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Coshocton, Jeff Drennan Ford, or Jeff Drennan's GM Superstore in Zanesville. And always remember, when you're thinking of buying a new car, it's time to talk to Jeff.
Lifestyle Home Furnishings in the Downtown or Plaza is your hometown furniture, mattress, and appliance store. Featuring everyday low prices, flexible payment plans, and our Lifestyle Smart Lease with 120 days same as cash, Lifestyle makes it easy and affordable to get the home furnishings you're looking for. Stop by or give us a call. Find us on Facebook or shop online at shoplifestylenow.com.
Lifestyle Home Furnishings, your life, your style, your home.
The National Anthem is being brought to you by the Coshocton Driver Training School, offering driver's education and adult remedial classes in Coshocton, Newcomerstown, Millersburg, Dresden, and New Philadelphia, with private lessons available upon request.
Thank you.
The Coshocton Driver Training School is proud to bring you the National Anthem. Now available in 5 convenient locations, the Driver Training School supports local athletes fighting on the field and fighting for our country. To schedule an appointment at any of the 5 locations, call 740-552-1639.
With Right Fuel now with the starting lineup. So as Ridgewood won the toss, and with the offensive starters, here's Chris Wallace.
Starting at quarterback is a senior at 205 pounds, number 3, Carter Fry. At the running back position is a 205-pound senior, number 9, Colin Smith. Wide receivers in the game is a 197-pound senior, number 26, Quincy Haynes, and a 170-pound senior, number 2, Josiah Cahill. Also at the wide receiver position is a 178-pound senior, number 80, Caleb Schrock. Also at wide receiver is a 141-pound junior, number 5, Mason Colvin. The offensive lineman in tonight's ball game, a 255-pound sophomore, number 78, Logan Sesser. A 240-pound senior, number 64, Cam Hirschberger. A 220-pound senior, number 63, Cohen Cabot. A 233-pound senior, number 56, Jonas Paul. And a 287-pound junior, number 50, Cam Stanton.
Now defensively for Malvern, the people we expect to see on the front side will be Julius Gore, number 55, Frank McClellan, number 76, and Kyle Bossert, number 73, and Chance Miller, defensive end, he's number 62. The linebackers will be Drake Hutchison, number 45, Manny Walker, number 32, Charles Moltz, number 28. In the secondary tonight, you'll see K.J. Waffler, number 17. Number 15 is Jared Witherow. Number 11, Rodney Smith. And number 1 will be Dylan Phillips. The starting lineups have been brought to you by R.J. Wright & Sons, an industry leader in providing complete residential and commercial fuel needs. R.J. Wright & Sons has locations in New Comerstown, New Philadelphia, and Caldwell. And we're just about ready to get underway here. Neither team has hit the field. We see Malvern at the east end getting ready to come on the field. Ridgewood now coming out as well. Chris, interesting game. 4-0 Malvern, 3-1 Ridgewood.
Absolutely. I don't think I realized it until either you and Casey said it in talking football or you and Coach Lesser talked about it, but it's been a long time since Ridgewood's had an opponent with a better record than them. And, boy, I can't even really remember until you maybe get the playoffs. But, yeah, big game. Ridgewood fans always show out here. It's a well-attended game. You take a look at the Malvern side, and it's a little bare on that side, but especially for a 4-0 team, as you mentioned in pregame, but a big game tonight. And, listening to Coach Lesser talking about Malvern really likes to spread the ball out and do a lot of passing around, and that's where Ridgewood's a little bit on the weaker side of things. They have a great offense and defensive line. They're great up front. So really looking forward to see what kind of attacks Malvern can do on that Ridgewood defense.
I think you made a good point there. That's the one thing Ridgewood wants to try to do. Is establish the run game early. That's reason, I think, the big reason they won the toss and elected to receive, because they want to start pounding the ball Malvern right away.
Absolutely. You got Colin Smith there at the running back position, and he's just 205-pound senior. He's just a beast. Coach Schlusser really talking about how well Colin Smith has been playing on the defensive side of things at the linebacker position, and he's a crucial role both offensively and defensively, so looking for a big game out of Colin Smith tonight.
All right, both teams have hit the field. We're just about ready to get things underway. Tonight's opening kick is brought to you by Dean's Jewelry in Coshocton and Mount Vernon. At Dean's Jewelry, they believe your jewelry experience should be fun. So the band is just about ready to leave the field. Ridgewood is over around Coach Schlusser getting their last-minute instructions. They'll be receiving to start this football game here this evening. Another beautiful night for football, no question about that.
A great night indeed, and a new feature: if you are watching the game on the WTNS YouTube channel, all you have to do is go to youtube.com and type in WTNS. A new feature we will be experimenting, or Casey Claxon will be experimenting with tonight, is the instant replay feature. So maybe you didn't see that touchdown, or you want to see if they were down, if they got that first down. That instant replay feature will be available on our WTNS YouTube video live stream, so we're looking forward to that tonight.
And throw
That'll help us too. You know, sometimes it gets a little dark, get the far side of the field. That'll give us an opportunity to make sure we tell you what's exactly going on.
Certainly will. Casey set up a little monitor here for us so we can actually watch the game as you're watching it at home. So look forward to that feature tonight. As you mentioned, you know, a big crowd on hand here on the Ridgewood side. Feels like the whole town comes out for this. The whole village comes out for a game like this, and looking forward as both teams are taking the field.
Yep, yeah, you're right. You know, looking around, as you mentioned, Malvern not really traveling real well tonight, but Ridgewood, they're going to have their contingency here, no question about that.
Absolutely, the Ridgewood faithful always shows out. Nothing like a Ridgewood football game where you get all the people parked outside the fence and their tailgates and hanging out and campfires and fireworks and touchdowns. It's a great atmosphere here tonight.
All right, and we should be just about ready to get things underway. There's an onside kick by Malvern, and Ridgewood gets on it quickly, and they'll have the ball in great field position.
Wow, that was a close call, and Ridgewood not expecting that and almost didn't get on the ball quickly there. You know, you always expect a big first kick, and Ridgewood was prepared.
Gives the Generals first and 10.
Yeah, those are the kind of things that can set you back right away, and nice job of covering that kick. All right, Ridgewood will come out of the huddle. The quarterback's going to be Carter Fry. Gets the snap, looking, just quick out to Schrock, has it. And they're right there on him, and he's actually going to lose a couple yards on that quick out. So a loss of, let's say, two, so it'll go from the
–
goes from the 44-yard line.
Second down, 12.
Charles Motz on the stop for the Hornets.
Back to the 42, so it'd be a loss of two, makes it a second and 12. Ridgewood setting up. They have trips to the right side. One to the left. Colin Smith offset. Man in motion there is going to be a motion penalty against Ridgewood.
Offsides against the Hornets.
So, actually, it's going to be against Malvern, so that'll be a five-yard mark off. So they'll get to put themselves in good field position as they cross the 45 out to the 47-yard line. First penalty of the ball game goes against the Hornets. Five-yard mark off, so about up to the 47-yard line. Makes it now a second and 7. Trips again, same formation. Colin Smith offset to the left side. Carter Fry hands it to Smith, looks for that, has a little hole, pounds across midfield, keeps those legs driving down to about the 45-yard line. That's going to be enough for a Ridgewood first down.
Yeah, great job by Colin Smith. Just gets the ball and keeps those legs chopping through the first contact, and nice run.
So they're going to give him the 45, so that's going to be a pickup of 8. So first and 10 for the Generals at the 45-yard line of the Hornets. Carter Fry, the quarterback, puts a man in motion across the formation. He's going to carry himself up inside, has some running room, crosses the 40 down to about the 37-yard line. So Fry gets 8. Just takes it right up the gut and picks up good yardage.
Linebacker Charles Motz with the stop again for the Hornets.
Second down and 2.
Second and 2, the situation.
Ball is at the 37-yard line.
Second and 2. Out of the huddle come the Generals. Now he changes Smith from the right to the left side. Everybody aligned. Man in motion across the formation. Straight back to throws. Fry now goes the other way. Little slant pattern drop by Caleb Schrock. So it'll bring up a third down and 2 situation. Just trying a little bubble screen, and pass was dropped, so that'll make it a 3rd-and-2 situation.
The first half of tonight's game is brought to you by Coshocton Recycling at the intersection of County Road 1A and Bridge Street. Coshocton Recycling is open Monday through Friday from 8 to 4:15.
All right, brings it up a 3rd-and-2 situation. Gets the snap. He's going to run it himself. Picks his way through. Got the first down. Keeps those feet moving and gets down to about the 32-yard line. So Fry's going to get 5.
That's good for a general.
So Carter Fry.
Walker on the stop for the Hornets.
Gets the first down there, second first down. Now the ball sitting at the 32, first and 10. Just underway from Ridgewood, 9:42 and moving in the opening quarter. Snap, handoff, Colin Smith, big hole, pounds it up inside, runs over one defender, gets inside the 25, down to about the 24-yard line. So another big gain on first down.
Colin Smith on the carry. Walker and Motz on the stop.
Manny Walker on the stop for the Hornets.
9 big yards. It'll be second down and one.
So we'll give him a 9 on the carry. So Colin Smith, 17 yards and a couple carries. Second down, and now it's going to be a long one, closer to 2. Handoff, speed sweep. Humphrey's got it. Has it to the 20. Just keeps churning
Humphrey
and gets
the
first
carry.
Down. So Matt Humphrey picks up the first down, their third here, and this impressive opening drive moves it down to the 19 for pickup of 5 yards on the play. So first and 10, the ball at the 19-yard line of the Hornets. Ridgewood splits 3 to the right side, 1 to the left. Colin Smith offset to the right side. Fry rolling to the right, looking, finds Schrock wide open. He's at the 15, gets to the 10, and is brought down inside the 10. But that's going to be enough for a first down. Picked up 11.
Picked up the 12 yards. That's good for a general.
KJ Waffler on the stop for the Hornets.
Mark it at the 8, so pick up of, as mentioned, 11 on the play. So that brings up a first and goal down at the 8-yard line. 8:40
and
moving.
From the 8.
Ready to go. There's a snap, handoff, Colin Smith, big hole right up the middle. He just pushes into the end zone. Touchdown Ridgewood. So Colin Smith just goes right up the middle and gets the touchdown. And we'll take another quick look at that to show you how it went. As you can see, hands it off inside, big hole at the 5, cuts it back up and into the end zone for the Ridgewood touchdown. So they'll come on, try to add the PAT. The Ridgewood, well, now wait a minute, that looks like they're going to try to go for 2. Carter Fry splits 3 to the right side. Puts a man in motion across formation. He's going to run it himself. They grab him. He just leaps and gets into the end zone for the two-point conversion. So Ridgewood adds on 2. They lead it 8-0. We'll be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
The Dairy Hut on Main Street in West Lafayette has the area's best sandwiches and burgers, ice cream, and fried favorites. Stop by and try their delicious food like the Kraken Burger, 4 pounds in all. They have the best in cold treats and good eats, plus low discount prices. Don't wait in line. Call in your order at 545-7579 and use their convenient drive-thru to pick it up. The Dairy Hut is open Monday through Saturday from 10 to 9 p.m. and Sunday from 11 to 9. Otsego Carryout in Coshocton is the only stop for whatever you need. Check out their deli, meat and cheese, a freshly made grab-and-go sandwich, and a large selection of Walnut Creek favorites. Check out these new items. A new selection of grab-and-go snacks and sandwiches, chocolate peanut butter fudge, and a large variety of deli meat and cheese. Stop by Otsego Carryout today. If they don't have it, you don't need it.
We're back and ready to start.
Phillips and
well, kicking off will be Ridgewood.
Starkey set to kick off for the Generals.
So Ridgewood gets on the board quickly with that touchdown and added the two-point conversion, and they'll kick off, and booming kick down the side hash and takes a bounce, and Malvern fields it at the 10, back to the 15, trying to get outside to the 20, cuts it upside 25 and out to about the 27.
Walker on the return.
Nice return
the ball out to the
for Malvern, and that's KJ Waffler with the return, so Malvern will have it first and 10 at the 27-yard line.
Number 17, Braylon Williams with the tackle on the kickoff.
Quarterback on the ball club is going to be Jared Witham. Witherow, a nice, he's a nice-looking sophomore QB, and we'll be looking forward to watching him play here this evening. First and 10 for the Hornets. Witherow, the quarterback, offset to the left side. There's a running back, Drake Hutchison. Gets a snap, back to throw. A little out pattern's going to be low. They're going to say no. Short hopped it, so that'll go as an incomplete pass. So Witherow misses on his first attempt of the evening. So we have second down and 10 situation. Ball still at the 27-yard line. Witherow taking his time, goes over and talks to the coaching staff before getting the play. Now returns to the huddle. Trips to the left side, one to the right. Hutchison is the running back, Witherow the quarterback. Gets the snap, rolling to the left side, pass a run. Now he throws it, and it's going to be incomplete, trying to find a little seam in the gap.
As for Phillips, incomplete.
And goes incomplete.
Third down, 10.
So it'll be a third and 10 situation. Ball still at the 27-yard line. And one thing Malvern I don't think can afford to do here tonight is have a lot of three and outs, especially early, because of Ridgewood with that looks like a strong running game.
Yeah, they certainly do. Ridgewood getting a lot of push up front on that defensive line as well. You know, I think you mentioned in pregame that Malvern only has two seniors on their football team.
So young team, no question. Straight back to throw, and blitz is on, throws it out. It's going to be picked off. Ridgewood has it down the sideline and being bumped out of bounds at the 20-yard line is going to be for the Generals. There's a flag, comes in late. So coming up with the interception is going to be Blake Wells, and a flag came in afterwards. So let's see what that call's all about. So a big interception, first turnover tonight in Ridgewood, an excellent field position. Let's wait and see if they mark anything else. On flag came in at the 14-yard line. While they mark it off, let's take another look at that interception.
We just saw a look at it while we were trying to figure out what's going on with the flag. I did see the
after the interception,
instant replay.
Block in the back, we believe, on the general.
And there was the instant replay for you.
They'll mark off the penalty from where,
as you can see, throwing out in the flat. Nice job by just stepping in front and coming up with a big INT. So the Generals, they were the ones that picked up the penalty blocking the back. So that's a 15-yard mark off. But Ridgewood has it first and 10 at the 30-yard line. With the football, the Generals. Carter Fry straight back to throw. A little bubble screen is going to be low, incomplete. Might not have gone very far anyway. Nice job by Malvern getting there defensively. So they'll bring up a second and 10 situation, trying to get the ball out to Colvin. So it goes incomplete, makes it a second and 10 situation, or second and 10. Second down and 10. Trips to the right, one to the left. Colin Smith offset the right side, gets a handoff up the middle, bounces outside, keeps his leg moving to 25, still dragging tacklers, gets down to around the 22-yard line. So Colin Smith gets 8 yards on the carry. Smith with 33 yards and 4 carries already, plus a touchdown. So he goes down to the 22, makes it a third and 2 situation. 7:40 to play here in the opening quarter.
Charles Motz on the stop for the Hornets.
Ridgewood out of the huddle, twin receivers left and right. Colin Smith directly behind now. He offsets to the left side. Carter Fry, the quarterback, gets the snap, hands it off to Smith. Powers, he's got the first down and more. Nice open field tackle from behind. Got him about the 17. But Colin Smith gets 5 more and a first down.
That was Ryan Runyon with the stop for the Hornets.
And Colin Smith... now up to 38 yards rushing and 5 carries. First and 10, number 5 for the Generals as they continue to move the ball effectively on the ground. Approaching the 7-minute mark here of the first quarter. Ridgewood with an 8-0 lead. Fry with the ball, rolls to the right side, pass a run. Now he's looking. Now throws it to the sidelines and overthrown, incomplete, and flag comes in late. That may be a hold. Let's wait and see.
Pass incomplete. Flag on the play.
Now still waiting on the call. It is a hold. That'll be a 10-yard mark off. That'll be their second penalty. Good for a total of 25 yards. So they'll mark that ball. Leaves them now with a third and 12 situation. As they mark it back to the 27-yard line. So I guess they must have picked up the first down. It's going to be a first and 20 situation. So offset to the left side is the running back. Fry looking. Now it goes to the right side. Now back to the left. He's still escaping. Now looking. Now he's going to go down as his knee touched down at about the 33 or 4-yard line. Look, wanted to cut back to the center of the field, but just stumbled a bit. That knee hit the ground, and it'll be marked back to the 34. So that's another loss of another 7 yards for the quarterback, Fry.
Loss of seven. Second down, 27.
Just didn't have enough. Well, had some time there, but just couldn't find an open receiver. Malvern doing a great job covering. Their secondary doing a great job covering those receivers.
Second and 27. Twin receivers left and right. Smith offset the left side. He gets a handoff. Bounces outside. Just runs over a tackler and pushes it down about the 31-yard line. So Colin Smith gets three
Smith
on the
on
carry.
The carry.
That'll bring up a third and 24 situation.
It's number 73. I didn't realize there was a back to this roster. Didn't think we had that one. 73, Kyle Bosart with the tackle for the Hornets.
So third and 24 for Ridgewood. 5:42 and moving here in the opening quarter. Fry the quarterback. Colin Smith offset to the left side. Gets the snap, fakes, looking to throw. Got a little bubble screen to Schrock, has it at 30. Gets outside the 25 and pushes forward to just beyond the 25. Well, actually, they're going to mark him exactly at the 25. So that bubble screen gets 5 yards on the play.
Fourth down, 17.
Actually gets six.
From the 25-yard line.
So it's a fourth down and 17 situation. In this situation, they'll probably go for it. The ball at the 25-yard line. Under five to play here in the opening quarter. Josiah Cahill getting in. He'll be one of the receivers on the left side. Cahill with great speed. Was a little dinged up last week and wasn't sure how much he'd play here this evening, but he's out there right now with trips to the right. He's lone set to the left. Fry back now looking for Cahill. They're going to go to the end zone. Shoots it down deep. There's a jump ball and pass is intercepted, and looks like Malvern might try to come out with it. That could be a mistake, and it is. It gets out only to the 5-yard line.
Pass intercepted.
So they get the interception.
Brought back out to the 5-yard line. Smith.
So the first turnover, but really not a bad situation for Ridgewood as they only returned it to the 5. That's where Malvern will have it, first and 10.
Instant replay there on the video, and you know if you're Malvern on that one, you almost better off batting it down as you're starting there at the 5. You'd have taken over on downs, but.
Or with the interception, all you have to do is take the knee and it comes out to the 20, so you don't even have to advance it. But, you know, they decided he thought he could get it out, but they're going to start deep in their own territory, first and 10. Ball at the 5. 4:32 to go here in the opening quarter. Out of the huddle, trips to the left side, trips to the right side, two to the left, with a row the quarterback, straight back. Now he's going to run it himself up the middle, has some running room, crosses the 10-yard line, gets out to about the 11. So just Jared Witherow just took it himself
Beans
and picked up
south,
some decent yardage and moved them out of the
Pick
shadow of their
six.
Own goal line.
Second down, 4.
It's linebacker Quincy Haynes with the tackle for the Generals.
So pickup of 6, second and 4. 4:10 to play here in the opening quarter. 8-0. Ridgewood scored on their opening drive, a touchdown run by Colin Smith, and Carter Fry added the two-point conversion. And that's where we stand with Malvern with the ball on their own 11-yard line. Second and four, straight back is Witherow. Throws a dump pass inside. It's incomplete. He sat down on the, and I think the quarterback thought he was going to move to the right side, but it goes incomplete. Witherow now 0-4 throwing the football with an interception, so that'll bring up a third and four situation. Clock stop with 3:46 to play here in the opening quarter. The Warehouse Steak and Stein is proud to sponsor tonight's Player of the Game. Tonight's Player of the Game will receive a gift certificate for a famous Warehouse cheeseburger and order of their legendary onion rings. This is courtesy of Warehouse Steak and Stein in Roscoe Village. Same formation, empty backfield, trips to the right, one to the left. Man in motion across formation. Quarterback keeps it himself, and he's not going to get there. Maybe got back to the line of scrimmage, so be no gain on the play for Witherow.
Paul and Sesser on the stop for the Generals. No gain.
So that'll bring on the punt team for Malvern.
That was Logan Sesser on the tackle for the Generals.
So Ridgewood will be in a position to come up with decent field position. They send two twin receivers back. Looks like Cahill and Schrock will be the receivers. High snap. Kick away. High booming kick. And ball is fumbled by Cahill. And he fortunately gets on it, but it's all the way back into their territory. So Ridgewood will have it. It'll be first and 10. Let's see where they mark. It looks like they'll mark it at the 39-yard line of the Generals. So they'll have it first and 10.
Taking a look at that replay. Ridgewood had a pretty good shot at blocking that, but kind of held up. Didn't want the penalty there. But we will let you know that the first half of tonight's game is brought to you by Coshocton Recycling at the intersection of County Road 1A and Bridge Street. Coshocton Recycling is open Monday through Friday from 8 to 4:15.
So ball at the 39, first and 10, 2:58 to play in the opening quarter. Ridgewood with the early lead, 8-0. Both teams on the field, ready to go. Quarterback's Carter Fry. Takes a quick look over at the coaching staff to get the play. They're changing it as we speak. Still plenty of time on the play clock. Fry. Hands the ball to Smith. Running room right up the middle. He crosses the midfield stripe, keeps pushing. Colin Smith takes it to the 49-yard line of Malvern for a pickup of 12, and that's a first down.
Yeah, nice job by Colin Smith. Just finds a hole and keeps those legs chopping through the first contact and takes two to bring him down.
Ball now at the 49 of the Hornets. They found a little bit of a weakness in that Malvern front, and they have pushed them down, and they've picked up some good yardage running the football here this evening. Smith now offset the left side. Carter Fry's going to keep it himself. He has some running room. He cuts it up inside. He's got a first down and keeps pushing, still pushing, and they finally get him down at the 35-yard line, so Carter Fry adds 14
Carter Fry
more.
With a pickup of 14
defensive
yards.
Back Dylan Phillips with the tackle for the Hornets.
So first and 10, first down number 7 for the Generals. Another moving the football. Matt Humphrey checks in the lineup. Caleb Schrock will come out. See if Humphrey lines up in the backfield. Let's wait and see. They come out, and he's going to be the slot receiver. Now he's shifting over to the left side. Down to 6 seconds. Coach Cabot might have to get a timeout now. They seem to be ready. He's down to three. Man in motion. They gave it to Humphrey on a speed sweep. Outside, hit, but he bounces off a tackle and finally driven out of bounds inside the 35-yard line.
On the carry.
See where they mark it.
Tackled by Smith.
Rodney Smith on the tackle for the Hornets.
So they're going to mark it at the there is a flag on the far side. Let's see what they call. This might be a motion penalty. Let's wait and see. It is a legal procedure on the Generals, so that'll be a 5-yard mark off. That'll be their third penalty here in the first quarter.
Procedure against the Generals
so
is the
call. So
that'll
push it back to the 40-yard line where it'll make it a first and 15. Clock running, 1:35 to play here in the opening quarter. Fry takes a quick glance over at the Ridgewood sidelines. Play clock down to 10 seconds. Fry still discussing it with Colin Smith. Now he's offset to the left side, down to four. Now they're ready. They got to get going. 1 second. Now Ridgewood wants a timeout, so we'll break away and be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Colonial Sports and Courts has been Coshocton's go-to fitness center since 1982. If you've never been to Sports and Courts, stop by and see what they have to offer. You can take advantage of a membership or a daily rate to use all their amenities. Sports and Courts offers silver sneakers, which you can use as a free membership. They have enough free weights and machines to reach all your fitness goals, racquetball courts, indoor basketball court, pool table, massage chair, and rooms available to rent. Also, if you're a personal trainer or fitness instructor, Colonial Sports and Courts is looking for you. For more information, stop by 1101 Ferry Falls Drive or call 740-623-8382.
Ridgewood wanted a timeout. They really didn't know what they wanted to call, and they got, as the play clock was down to about 2 seconds, they got the quick timeout. So seem to be ready to go now. It's first and 15, the ball on the Malvern 40. 1:15 to play in the opening quarter. There's a snap. Handoff is up the middle and picking up some decent yardage on the play. So maybe the, let's see where they're going to mark him. Looks like the 40 or the 37-yard line. That was Matt Humphrey, the ball carrier. Oh, wait a minute, that might be Sparger. Let's wait and see. Yeah, is that Aiden Sparger with a carry? So he picked up three. So Sparger gets three. Makes it a second and 12 situation. Offset to the right side is going to be Sparger. Hand off again. Sparger has it. Crosses the 35. Keeps pushing down inside the 35 to about the 33-yard line.
Sparger on the carry.
Tackled by a host of Hornets.
So Sparger gets four eight on that carry. So that'll bring down bring up a third and eight situation. Penalties have bothered the Generals here. They've had decent drives. And that's going to be the last play of the first quarter. So at the end of one, it's Ridgewood 8, Malvern nothing. We'll be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
With American National Life Insurance, you get coverage options that can be tailored to your individual or group needs, including whole life, term life, and universal life insurance. That combined with an agent who is ready to provide knowledgeable personal service for your financial security. Let the John Ainello Insurance Agency be your insurance ally. Call us today at 740-295-9460. American National Insurance Company, Galveston, Texas.
Petticord Rice LePage Auction Realty is a full-service auction and real estate company. Whether on-site or online auctions, their auction staff will handle every aspect of your auction, from setup to completion. And for real estate, they will take you through all of the necessary steps of buying or selling your property. They would love the opportunity to serve you. For appointments or free consultations, call 740-622-3111 or visit their website. At Petticord Rice LePage Auction Realty, they don't just list homes, they sell them.
We're back and getting ready to start period number two. Just a quick number of interest. In the first quarter, Ridgewood ran 23 offensive plays compared to only six for Malvern, and Ridgewood has the 8-0 lead as we prepare to get things underway here in the second quarter.
Also let you know the first half of tonight's game is brought to you by Coshocton Recycling at the intersection of County Road 1A and Bridge Street. Coshocton Recycling is open Monday through Friday from 8 to 4:15.
Okay, ready to go. Fry the quarterback, Colin Smith back in. Third and eight. Ball sitting at the 33-yard line of the Malvern Hornets. They're ready to go. Trips to the right side. Fake. Fry rolls right. Has a receiver. Throws it over, and it's going to be wide right, incomplete, and that will bring up a fourth down situation.
Pass incomplete.
I got to believe Ridgewood feels comfortable enough going for it right here on fourth down.
I would have to agree with you there. Get the field position and, well.
Well, maybe they want to pin him back. Let's see. It looks like they're, or it could be a fake. With these guys, you never, Cahill's going to be the up man. So they're in punt formation at their 33-yard line. So let's wait and see what they do. They faked it two of the last 3 weeks. This time they're good. They go through and they just kick it high in the air over towards the far sideline, bounces back, and Ridgewood will have it. Down it at the 15, so that's where Malvern will take over, first and 10. So another drive, second time inside Malvern Hornet territory that the drive is stalled.
Hathaway Incorporated is proud to help sponsor tonight's ball game. They encourage all students, whether in athletics, academics, or the arts. Good luck in all you strive to accomplish. Hathaway Incorporated, building for the future.
First and 10 for the Hornets. They have the ball on their own 15-yard line. With a row, the quarterback, Drew Hutchison, offset to the right side. There's a snap, hands it off inside, spins right into another tackler, and he goes down immediately. Looks like a loss of a couple on the play.
Number 64, Cam Hershberger with the big stop for the Generals. Tackle for a loss.
Hershberger and Sessor on the stop for the Generals. Loss of two, second down 12.
Second and 12. Just underway in the second quarter, Ridgewood with the early lead, 8-0. Hornets out of the huddle, will send trip receivers to the left side, one to the right. Hutchison offset with a row on the left side. There's a snap straight back, rolling to the right. Now throws it over the middle, pass is almost intercepted, went right through the receiver's hands.
Pass
looked like it was
going
to be a completion,
third
but Dylan
12.
Phillips not able to hang on to it. So it'll bring up a third and 12 situation. Right now, Witherow is 0 of 5 throwing the football, plus an interception.
Malvern currently 0 for 3 on third down conversions.
So third down and 12. To this point, they have not been able to mount any offense. And really, to be honest, Ridgewood's been their own worst enemy with penalties as they bogged down a couple times in Malvern territory. Once again, trips to the left, one to the right. Witherow with the quarterback, straight back at his four-yard line. Now throws a deep ball down the sideline. Let's see. It's going to be incomplete. And decent coverage, and it'll go bring up a fourth down situation. For Ridgewood, that's Matt Humphrey back there defensively.
Yeah, good job defensively. Almost had his receiver open and had a pretty nice thrown ball. And pretty close there, but.
So it'll be a punting situation. Ridgewood will drop Cahill back. He'll be back around his
Cahill back deep
50,
the
about the, near the 50-yard line. So Malvern has been three and out on all occasions thus far. New ball coming in. Now we're ready to go. He'll be standing right around his goal line. There's a snap, good snap, gets it away. Oh, it's a short kick, kind of shanked it to the left. Now gets a good bounce, though. It'll roll out of bounds. Oh, no, it won't. It'll just roll dead out at the 45-yard line. That's where Ridgewood will take over, first and 10.
Malvern punt rolls dead at the 45-yard line.
Had a lot of height on the punt, just didn't go too far, but took a nice Malvern bounce. And 45, Ridgewood will take over.
Warehouse Steakenstein is proud to sponsor tonight's Player of the Game. Tonight's Player of the Game receive a gift certificate for a famous Warehouse cheeseburger and order their legendary onion rings. This is courtesy of Warehouse Steakenstein in Roscoe Village. So the Generals have it, first and 10 on the Malvern 45. Come out of the huddle, receiver left and right.
Cahill at quarterback.
Yep, Cahill's now in at quarterback. Man in motion across the formation, Schrock. Now he'll line up. KO has it, and he's going to go left side. He's a runner. He takes it up inside and just goes straight
Cahill
ahead.
On the keeper.
Crosses the 40 down to about the 39-yard line.
Tackled by 55 for the Hornets.
So Cahill picks up six on his first carry of the night.
Julius Gore on the tackle for
Pick
the Hornets.
Pick up a six. Second down, four.
Ball at the 39. Second and four. Out of the huddle. Cahill. Schrock's in the slot. There's a snap. Hand off into no. Cahill keeps it himself. Has the first down. Keeps running up the middle. And gets down about the 30. He rode the fullback Smith into the line. Kept it himself. And took it all the way down to the 29-yard line. So Josiah Cahill gets 10 on the carry.
Miller on the stop for the Hornets.
He has 16 yards and a couple carries, and it'll be first down number 8 for the Generals.
First and 10 at the 29-yard line.
Chance Miller on the stop for the Hornets.
Once again, Ridgewood pushing deep into Malvern territory. This has been kind of the scenario here most of the evening. Cahill has Sparger in the slot. Fakes, keeps it himself again, has running room, a lot of running room, bounces the outside. He's going to take it to the house. Josiah Cahill scores, touchdown, Ridgewood. So Josiah Cahill just rode the fullback once again, took it himself, and into the end zone he goes for the score.
Yeah, nice touchdown by Josiah Cahill. If you're watching on our YouTube channel, take a look at the replay. Finds a nice hole and really breaks it outside.
And Ridgewood now out in front 14-0. And once again, they'll try to go for two. So that's a 29-yard scamper for Cahill.
I believe they're going to go for the point after.
So now they'll kick this time. Starkey on to do the kicking. Good snap. Kick is high enough, long enough, and off to the left side's no good. So with 9:32 to play here in the opening half, Ridgewood extends their lead to 14-0. We'll be back. This is high school football on WTNS. Koshaka.
When you are good at something, you'll tell everyone. When you are great at something, they'll tell you. Walter Payton. At Liddy Scrapyard, we have been told how great we are. So for a great scrap recycling experience, visit Liddy Scrap. We have the cleanest scrapyard, best customer service, and great pricing. Liddy Scrap is located at 23820 County Road 621, Coshocton. Feel free to call us anytime at 740-622-6220. Our hours of operation are Monday through Friday, 8 to 4:15, and Saturday, 8 to 11:45. We would also like to wish all the air.
When it comes to service, nobody cares more than Village Motors in Millersburg. This is Deke Miller, and I'm proud to say that we have state-of-the-art equipment and factory-trained technicians working on your vehicle when you visit. And we also offer a variety of preventative maintenance programs designed to greatly reduce the cost of your service visits. We are competitive, convenient, and we care. So the next time you need your vehicle service, stop by and see us at Village Motors in Millersburg.
We'll be kicking off. They're out in front, 14-0. 9.5 to play here in the first half.
Starkey set to kick off for the Generals.
Starkey will be kicking for the Generals. Back deep for Malvern will be Waffler and Phillips. End over end. Waffler takes it at the 12-yard line. He's back to the 20. Cuts it up to 25. Has the 30. Still pushing and is brought down as he crossed the 30 to about the 32-yard line. So that's where Malvern, that best field position of the night, will start first and 10.
Haynes and Eckleberry on the stop for the Generals.
So be at the 32. First and 10.
Malvern has it first and 10 at the 32-yard line.
To date, Malvern not able to get really anything going offensively. Witherow comes in 0 of 6 throwing the football. Right now, they only have two total yards of offense in this first half. Man in motion, cross formation, speed sweep, trying to get outside, looking for a place to run. Ridgewood's got him hemmed in, and he's going to be brought down for a loss. Just nowhere to go with that good defense. That's Phillips, the ball carrier. Dylan Phillips. Looks like he loses a yard.
And Davis on the stop for the Generals. No gain. Second down, 10.
Yeah, they're going to give him back the line of scrimmage. Not quite sure he got there. So be a no gain. It'll be a second and 10 situation. Ridgewood, even last week, just couldn't get off the field on third down on a lot of different occasions. And just that quarterback that West Branch had, very effective getting those, moving the markers. And now we've got a timeout by Malvern. So we'll break away and be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
This is Jamie from the Coshocton Coffee Connection. Did you know that we serve breakfast sandwiches all day, every day? Our made-to-order breakfast sandwiches include a fresh egg, melted cheese, and your choice of biscuit, bagel, croissant, or my favorite, onion flatbread. Next, choose from sausage or locally purchased bacon. Enjoy that same bacon for lunch on our BLTs, grilled cheese, and turkey bacon clubs. Pair any of our sandwiches with a hot, made-fresh daily bowl of soup. Let us complete your order by making you a specialty coffee or tea. Stop by and see us at the Coshocton Coffee Connection.
14-0, Ridgewood out in front, 8:34 to play here in the first half. Malvern took the timeout. They've just had a difficult time picking up any yardage here thus far tonight. And coach over there just kind of wanting to talk things out a little bit, so trying to get some comfort for the Hornets. They come in undefeated at 4-0. And have really struggled here this evening.
Yeah, kind of relied on that their passing game a lot, and you know, kind of did a couple three and outs there with just a few incomplete passes, and really starting to run the ball now.
All right, now they're back on the field and lined up. Have a couple receivers to the left, one to the right. Hutchison offset to the right side. Quarterback keeps it himself, looks like some room, but boy, Ridgewood closes it down quickly. Quarterback does a nice job just lunging across the 35 to the 36-yard line.
On the tackle for the Generals.
So Witherow manages to get four on the carry.
Third down, six.
So I'll make it a third and six situation. Colin Smith checking back in for the defense.
That was linebacker Quincy Haynes with the tackle for the Generals.
All right, out of the huddle. Third and six. Witherow has Hutchison offset to the left side. Back to throw, looking, has a receiver open, and he's got him. Let's see where they mark it. Looks like he had enough for the first down, and they're going to give it to him. They're going to say it was, they're going to mark it all the way out to the
The far side
44.
Official.
I think he had that a little bit off, but
the far side official was about 2 yards.
After the spot, that results in a first down for the Hornets.
So they complete their first pass of the evening for 8 yards and a first down, their first down of the ball game. So first and 10, 7:30 to play, ball out at the 44-yard line. Witherow sends them out, trips to the right side, one receiver to the left. Witherow has Phillips offset the left side. Hands it off inside. Boy, there's no running room. That was Hutchison, and he got thrown for a couple-yard loss. A Ridgewood player comes out with a football, but they're going to say he was down.
First one there for the Generals.
So they get him down back at the 42 for a loss of two on the play.
Second down, 12.
Logan Sesser with the big hit for the Generals.
So now this brings up a second and 12. 14-0 here at Ridgewood. Generals have scored a touchdown in each quarter and had a two-point conversion. That's where we stand, 14-0. Malvern out of the huddle. They'll stack three to the right side. Hutchison off lined up the right. Witherow back to throw, now in trouble. Trying to look, he's hit as he releases. It goes incomplete. Blitz was on, and big hit on the play. And
pressure on the play by Quincy Haynes.
So big pressure by Ridgewood. That'll bring up a third and 12 situation.
Third down, 12.
Yeah, Quincy Haynes had a nice blitz on the play. Went up untouched into the quarterback, and he laid a pretty good hit there.
So now a third down situation. He rolled to his right side, but they're just really nowhere to go with the football, and really tried to throw back, but he was hit just as he released, and the pass came up well short. So third and 12, our situation. Now twin running backs. Witherow straight back to throw, looking. Now he scrambles out. Now he's in trouble, but eludes one tackler. Stillway's way back, and he's going to be brought down for a monster loss all the way back. Now we got a penalty flag coming in.
Cohen Parsons.
He was brought down all the way back at the 14-yard line. There's a flag came in after the fact.
Flag on the play.
Let's see if this is a personal foul call. It almost has to be.
Tell you, that was a big hit by Cohen Parsons.
That was a 22-yard loss if the play stands.
It didn't look too aggressive from what I saw.
It must have been the reaction afterwards is the only thing I can think of. Unsportsmanlike against Ridgewood.
Dead ball foul.
That'll be a 15-yarder.
Unsportsmanlike conduct against the Generals.
And, really, there wasn't a lot to it. It's just, kid made a great play and showed that. Then sometimes you wonder about those kind of calls. But still, it's going to be fourth and forever for Malvern, and they'll be forced to punt again. Quincy Haynes and Caleb Schrock
still
back.
Still fourth and 23.
There's the snap. Kick, booming kick. That's going to send Schrock back, and he picks it up at his 25 and tries to keep going. Is brought down. Good coverage by Malvern. He gets down to the 28-yard line, and that's where Ridgewood will take over.
Rowan
first
Ball
and 10.
Was the first one there for the Hornets.
So first down for the Generals. 5:51 to play here in the first half. Ridgewood with the ball, sitting at the 27-yard line.
The Coshocton Coffee Connection wants to remind you that all drinks, all sizes, are half-priced every Wednesday. Have your favorite made hot, iced, or frozen. They open Monday through Saturday at 6 a.m. and are open Wednesdays until 5 p.m.
First and 10. Out of the huddle come the Generals. Schrock to the right side. Carter Fry back at quarterback. And now they empty the backfield. Fry straight back to throw, looking, now looks left, right, throws it out in the flats, got his receiver, and he's going to be hit almost immediately. I think they're going to give him the 32-yard line, so the pass is good for 5 yards.
Fry to Lommers complete.
Drake Hutchinson on the tackle for the Hornets.
So Lommers makes the reception, so that'll bring up a
second down six.
Second and six situation. Ball at the 32-yard line. Once again, Schrock wide to the right. Colin Smith offset to the right side. Fry, the quarterback, gets the snap. He's going to run it himself up inside. Has some running room. Hatch pushes out, gets the first down as he crosses the 40. Out to looks like the 41-yard line. So Fry gets 9 on the carry.
Pick up a
first down,
yards.
Number
That'll
9 for the Generals as they move it out to the 41-yard line. Clock moving as we hit the 5-minute mark here in the first half. 14-0, Ridgewood with the lead. Twin receivers wide left and right. There's a snap, handoff inside to Smith. Powers his way through across the midfield stripe and close to the first down number. So Colin Smith continues his fine running. Let's see where they mark it. It's going to mark it a little short, so we'll give him 9 on the carry.
Pickup of 9.5 yards.
Second and 1. Ball on the 49-yard line of the Hornets. Ridgewood has been effective using that ground game here in the first half. They lead it 14-0. There's a snap. Hand off Smith once again. That's the first down. He's at 45.
Colin Smith on the carry.
Maybe to the 44 before
Pick
being brought down.
4 yards. That'll be good for a general.
So ball will be at the 44. Colin Smith another 5 yards on the carry. First and 10. Number 10 for the Ridgewood Generals here in the first half. 3:53 and moving. Ridgewood's been a methodical first half for the Generals. Two left. Fry takes a look. Man in motion across the formation. He's going to keep it himself. Has some running room. plows forward inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Another five-yard pickup for Ridgewood.
Pickup of 5 yards, second down five.
They've done it on the ground here this evening.
Bossert on the stop for the Hornets.
Kyle Bossert on the stop for the Hornets.
Second down and five. Same formation. They've done a great job running out of this thing. Fry, the quarterback, hands it off inside, bounces outside. He's got some running room. Sparger, he's going to be hit and dropped. I'll see if he's got the necessary yards. Looks like they're going to mark him right at the 35. So that'll be a pickup of four for Sparger. He has 11 yards
and
three carries.
Pick up 4.5 yards, be third and one again.
So third and short for Ridgewood. Wholesale substitutions for the Generals. 2:40 and moving here in the first half. 14-0, Ridgewood in front. Carter Fry gets the play from the sideline, comes out. Now he's going under center, wing T formation this time for the Generals. Man in motion, hand off inside to Smith. He just powers forward and gets the first down to around the 32-yard line. So 3 yards for
Colin Smith.
Gives the Generals
first
Smith.
And 10 at the 32.
First down, number 11.
With 18 seconds to go in the half.
First and 10 again. This time the ball's in at the 32. Ridgewood, just wholesale substitutions left and right. Out of the huddle they come, hit the 2-minute mark here of the first half. They have two timeouts remaining, so that's not an issue. Ball at the 33. Fake handoff to Smith. This time they close it down as he gets to the 30-yard line. So a short gain of 2 on the play. Stops the clock, and Ridgewood will take a timeout. We'll break away and be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Are you concerned about the economy, interest rates, or current market conditions? For timely information based on award-winning research, call Raymond James Financial Advisor Shane Pyle at 622-3110. Shane can discuss your specific needs and provide you with investment choices that make sense for you. Call Shane Pyle at 622-3110 in Coshocton for an appointment. Raymond James Financial Services, member FINRA SIPC. Life well planned.
We're back. Minute 43 to go in the first half. Ridgewood used their second timeout. The ball's sitting at the 30-yard line. At this stage, I think they're going to have to throw it around a little bit, try to make something happen.
Yeah, you know, the Malvern quarterback has a pretty good arm, and
so now here we go. Second down. Ball at the 30 for the Generals. Fry straight back to throw. Looking, now escapes one guy. Now there's a flag, comes in left, throws it deep down the center of the field, and it's intercepted. And it's going to bring back to the 10, the 15, the 20, the 25, and out of bounds. And a flag comes in, and my suspicion is it's going to be a hold, and I think that it'll be a turnover for Ridgewood. Let's wait and see what the call is.
Malvern brings the ball out to...
It was, and Malvern declines it, so Malvern holds and gets the football back with 1:30 to go here in the first half.
The penalty
so
is declined.
Third time tonight that Ridgewood has been stopped inside the 30-yard line of Malvern. So good job defensively by the Hornets. So out of the huddle will be Malvern. Let's see what they do with a minute and 30 to go here. They've struggled all night moving. They've actually got negative yardage in the first half. So let's see if they try to do anything fancy or just kind of try to get into the locker room and readjust. We're ready to go. Witherow, the quarterback, gets it, hands it off to Hutchinson, goes wide, has some running room for the first time, moves it all the way out close to the 35-yard line. Let's see where they mark it officially. Looks like they're going to say he stepped out of bounds at the 30.
Run out of bounds by Smith. 1 minute and 25 seconds to go in the half.
So pick up second down six and three for the Hornets
from the 30-yard line.
So second down, he did get out of bounds and stop the clock with 1:25. Second and four. Two receivers left, one right. There's a snap, handoff once again. Hutchison goes outside again. This time picked up a couple, but is brought down. Clock continues to move. I think they gave him the 32-yard line. So he gets two on the carry.
Jonas Paul on the tackle for the Generals.
So third and two. Yeah, I'm going to say really closer to third and one. Ball at the 32-yard line. Under a minute to play here in the first half. 14-0 Ridgewood out in front here on a beautiful night for football in West Lafayette. Play clock at six. Witherow, the quarterback. Let's see if they try to get the, he's going to throw, try to get the first down. A little wild pattern's caught. It's going to be enough for the first down as he got out to, yeah, that far line, Judge. He gives you about an extra yard about every time. He got it 8 yards out to the 40.
Very generous.
Smith on the reception. Cahill
so
on the
it's stop. A first down there, second of the ball game.
First and 10 from the 40.
Josiah Cahill with the tackle for the Generals.
Clock moving, under 30 seconds to play here in the first half. Ridgewood scored a touchdown in each quarter and lead it 14-0. Trips to the left side this time, one to the right. Witherow the quarterback, Hutchison offset. Now Witherow rolls out, big pressure's on, throws it deep down. He's got a man open. Let's see if he can get to it. It's through his arms, but he had him open. Just a little long, incomplete. And that was a breaking free was K.J. Waffler. But with 9 seconds Waffler to go, that'll bring up a second and 10.
Pass attempt there.
No and good. With only 9 seconds left, we'll let you know that the first half of tonight's game is brought to you by Coshocton Recycling at the intersection of County Road 1A and Bridge Street. Coshocton Recycling is open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 4:15.
9 seconds to play. Witherow with the quarterback, hands it off to Hutchison inside, has a lot of running room this time, crosses midfield. Keeps those legs moving. Finally brought down at the 40 with 2 seconds to go. They got the first down. That's a big run.
Yeah, absolutely. Broke off a nice speed sweep out there to the outside on the far side. And
40 to the 40. That's a pickup of 20.
Parker was the first one there for the Generals.
It looks like Malvern's going to get a
timeout. Timeout, Malvern. So 2 seconds to go in the half.
Malvern gets a timeout, so with 2 seconds to go, they'll try for one more play. So we'll break away and be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Coshocton Regional Medical Center is committed to prioritizing the safety of our patients. That promise of better care is reflected in our achievement of a Leapfrog Hospital Safety Grade A for safety excellence and a top 10% ranking for patient safety in the nation from Health Grades 2 years in a row. We strive to be the gold standard of care and have demonstrated that pledge to every patient with our commitment to patient safety. Coshocton Regional Medical Center, where care matters most.
All right, Malvern has met with the coaching staff. They will, this will be, barring a penalty, the last play of the first half. So out of the huddle they come. Witherow the quarterback. Hutchison will be offset. Trips left side, one right. As mentioned, the ball on the Ridgewood 40. Straight backs Witherow. He's in trouble, being flushed out. Throws it away, incomplete. And that's, I think, will be the end of the first half. Let's wait and see. Everybody heads to the locker room. We've played one half of football, and Ridgewood is out in front of Malvern 14-0. We'll be back. This is high school football on WTNS Coshocton.
Hey, it's me. Well, you from the future. Let's talk budget. Gas prices are going up, you blew your budget buying groceries, and here comes your bill for car insurance. Now, that's one bill you can control when you choose Erie Insurance.
Do your future self a favor and ask about Rate Lock from Erie.
The only thing going down is the waistline on our jeans. Yep, low rise are back in again. Ugh.
Your local Erie agent in Coshocton is Albertson Lawrence Agency. Get a quote today.
Go to ErieInsurance.com for company licensure and product details.
Coshocton Opportunity School has the highest graduation rate out of 86 similar programs in the state of Ohio and is rated as exceed standards in all areas of graduation. They have a combined administrative experience of 55 years and a combined teaching experience of 127 years. They offer the state-required core curriculum, a career-based instruction program, and several electives including art, life skills, parenting, and relationship building. If you are interested in applying, please call 740-623-3600. Greeno's Pizza in the Downtowner Plaza has a new pizza special. Enjoy the game with five large, one-topping pizzas for only $47.99. That's under $10 for a large pizza loaded from crust to crust with one topping. You can now earn points for rewards to redeem on food items. They have increased their delivery drivers to help you get your Greeno's pizzas, subs, and salads even quicker. You can order online at crenospizzaco.com or give them a call in Coshocton at 740-295-9611. Fall is almost here, and there's a lot to do and see at Shoemaker Farms. Shoemaker Farms has all your fall decorating accessories like pumpkins, gourds, mums, cornstalks, straw bales, apples, squash, and of course, homemade cookies. They also have tomatoes, zucchini, cucumbers, produce, and did I mention homemade cookies? Located between Coshocton and West Lafayette on County Road 16, Shoemaker Farms is open Monday through Saturday, 9 a.m. until 6, and Sunday from 10 until 4. Stay tuned for hayrides to the pumpkin patch every Saturday and Sunday in October.
Lifestyle Home Furnishings in the Downtowner Plaza is your hometown furniture, mattress, and appliance store. Featuring everyday low prices, flexible payment plans, and our Lifestyle Smart Lease with 120 days same as cash, Lifestyle makes it easy and affordable to get the home furnishings you're looking for. Stop by or give us a call. Find us on Facebook or shop online at shoplifestylenow.com. Lifestyle Home Furnishings, your life, your style, your home.
It was 70 years ago when CES Credit Union started serving individuals and families with better rates, lower fees, and real value. Many names have changed and disappeared, but CES Credit Union remains, focused on you, for you. We will do the right thing, do it better, and keep it local. CES Credit Union, federally insured by NCUA, Mount Vernon, Delaware, Loudonville, Utica, and now Coshocton. CESCU.com. Welcome to CES Credit Union.
Shop, the number one marketplace for coaches, headquartered in Coshocton, Ohio, and proud corporate sponsor of Ohio High School Football Coaches Association. Well, the Generals scored in both quarters. They got on the board with 8:23 to go in the opening quarter on this play.
There's a snap, handoff, Colin Smith, big hole right up the middle. He just pushes into the end zone, touchdown, Ridgewood.
So Colin Smith scores on an 8-yard touchdown run. The Generals go for two, and Carter Fry gets the 2-point conversion, and that makes it 8-0. Stayed that way to early in the second quarter with 9:32 to play. Ridgewood scored on this play.
As Sparger in the slot, takes, keeps it himself again, has running room, a lot of running, and bounces the outside. He's going to take it to the house. Josiah Cahill scores, touchdown, Ridgewood.
Generals get the score, but they miss the PAT, and that's where we stand at halftime, 14-0. We'll be back and get to the halftime show in a moment. This is high school football on WTNS Coshocton.
If you're a business or do-it-yourselfer looking for the best possible siding for your home or office, then stop by MRV Siding Supply. They offer the number one rated panel on the market, Cedar Max Super Polymer Insulated Siding by Provia. Cedar Max provides outstanding performance inside and out with impact resistance, impervious to moisture, flame retardant, and noise reduction, giving you peace of mind. For Cedar Max Super Polymer Insulated Siding by Provia, call MRV Siding Supply at 800-524-7436. Visit them on the web at mrvsiding.com.
Coshocton Regional Medical Center is committed to prioritizing the safety of our patients. That promise of better care is reflected in our achievement of a Leapfrog Hospital Safety Grade A for safety excellence and a top 10% ranking for patient safety in the nation from HealthGrades 2 years in a row. We strive to be the gold standard of care and have demonstrated that pledge to every patient with our commitment to patient safety. Coshocton Regional Medical Center, where care matters most.
Life is full of uncertainties. What happens to your assets after you pass away shouldn't be one of them. At Raymond James Financial Services, we offer a transfer on death agreement that allows your estate to be held in a brokerage account, so it avoids the probate process and goes directly to your heirs. To find out how to make things easier for your loved ones, call financial advisor Shane Pyle at 622-3110, located in Coshocton. Raymond James Financial Services, member FINRA/SIFIC. Life well planned.
In life, you get what you pay for, and you always look to save a little extra cash. But when it comes to your car, do you really want to cut corners? Or do you want to make sure, in the event of an accident, you get your vehicle fixed the right way? Brilhart's Body Shop will give you the quality, attention to detail, and satisfaction you deserve when getting your vehicle fixed. Give Brilhart's Body Shop a call at 740-622-0121 or stop by 622 Main Street in Coshocton. Keep your vehicle on the road with new tires or mechanical work from Shriver Tire Service. Shriver Tire offers new tires for passenger, truck, and farm vehicles, as well as light mechanical work. Custom wheels are now available, as well as financing. Shriver Tire is now an authorized dealer for Falcon Tires. For more information, stop by 2171 Otsego Avenue or give them a call at 622-6989.
Ford F-Series is America's most popular full-size truck. This is Jay Shepler letting you know that no one will sell you a new Ford for less than Jeff Drennan Ford. This month only, you can push, pull, or drag your trade-in to Jeff Drennan Ford and get a minimum of $2,500. Our lot is full of new and used trucks, from Rocky Ridge lifted F-150s to diesel work trucks and everything in between. Check out our inventory online at jeffdrennanford.com or on South 2nd Street in Coshocton.
Domino's Pizza in Coshocton and Newcomerstown has a new pizza deal. You can now get any large specialty pizza or a large pizza any way you want it for only $14.99. That's right, $14.99 each, pickup or delivery. Try our Philly cheesesteak, chicken bacon ranch, or our barbecue chicken specialty pizzas today. Call the Coshocton Domino's at 622-9345 or in Newcomerstown at 498-4131 and get your large specialty pizza for only $14.99.
Art Saylor here from Saylor Wealth Strategies. Most people assume they need a large amount of wealth to hire a financial advisor. Not true. I think outside the box to customize a plan for the individual. I also educate my clients along the way about how and why a plan can help and work for them. The key is to have a plan. If you'd like more information or to schedule a free consultation, call Saylor Wealth Strategies at 740-575-4782. We're here to help you achieve your financial goals. Securities offered through registered representatives of Cambridge Investment Research, Inc., a broker-dealer, member FINRA, SIPC. Advisory services offered through Cambridge Investment Research Advisors, Inc., a registered investment advisor. Saylor Wealth Strategies, LLC, and Cambridge are not affiliated.
If you are involved in an accident, you want your vehicle to be repaired quickly and correctly? I'm Stacy Rice, Office Manager of Coshocton Inclusion, where we put you, the customer, first. We complete your auto body repairs as promised, we guarantee our work, and we use the latest environmental friendly paint products from PPG. Whenever you are involved in a collision, come to Coshocton Inclusion Center, 225 Main Street in Town Center, Coshocton, across from Wilson's Carpet and Furniture, or call us at 623-7347.
ITM Marketing has 50 immediate openings for qualified individuals. They're looking to hire fun, upbeat, and professional individuals for first shift inbound customer service. Excellent verbal and written communication skills plus computer skills are required. Benefits include paid vacation, health insurance, and 401k. Individuals must be able to work hours from 8:30 to 5 p.m. Monday through Friday, and base pay is $15 per hour. Please send resumes to hr@itmmarketing.com or apply online at itmmarketing.com. No phone calls, please.
Individual commitment to a group effort. That is what makes a team work, a company work, a society work, a civilization work. Vince Lombardi. This is Brandon Smith from Liddy Scrapyard. Commitment is something we believe in. Commitment from our employees to our customers, schools, and community. This is why we are happy to support this high school football broadcast. For great service and current competitive pricing, Give Liddy Scrapyard a call, 740-622-6220, or visit us on County Road 621, just behind ODOT at the west edge of Canal Louisville.
I'm Malcolm. I'm a commercial cash management specialist, but I'm also a leader and a musician.
At Park National Bank, we're more than our job titles, and you're more than an account number. You get personal attention and direct access to a caring, compassionate banker who respects and responds to your needs and goals. Find Malcolm or a banker near you at parknationalbank.com. Park National Bank, where you mean more. Member FDIC, parknationalbank.com.
Ridgewood High School, the halftime band show is brought to you by Domino's Pizza in Coshocton and New Commerce Town. We are now going to send it to the field for the live halftime band show.
Folker, auxiliary director Bethany Helmick, and percussion instructor David Hochstetler. The band is conducted on the field by Commander Zoe Allen. The band will be playing part of this year's show entitled Matters of the Heart. Songs include Total Eclipse of the Heart, Don't Go Breaking My Heart, and Closer to the Heart.
Halftime band show was brought to you by Domino's Pizza. Call them today in Coshocton at 622-9345 or in New Comerstown at 498-4131.
At Domino's Pizza in Coshocton and New Comerstown, we have new items available on our mix and match for delivery. Get these items for only $6.99 when you buy two or more medium two-topping pizzas or any of our multiple side items. All of these great options are only $6.99 each, delivered to you when you buy two or more. Keep the entire family happy and order what they want with our mix and match deal. Call the Coshocton Dominoes at 622-9345 or in Newcomers Town at 498-4131.
Lifestyle Home Furnishings in the Downtowner Plaza is your hometown furniture, mattress, and appliance store. Featuring everyday low prices, flexible payment plans, and our Lifestyle Smart Lease with 120 days same as cash, Lifestyle makes it easy and affordable to get the home furnishings you're looking for. Stop by or give us a call. Find us on Facebook or shop online at shoplifestylenow.com. Lifestyle Home Furnishings, your life, your style, your home.
Nation, we know how it feels when a company doesn't treat you like a priority. You feel small. Or worst of all, like you're just a voice in a crowd. At Nationwide, we put members first. Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
To join the nation, call Scott Boyer in Coshocton today at 740-622-2131.
Subject to underwriting guidelines, review, and approval. Availability and details vary. Nationwide Mutual Insurance Company and Affiliates, Columbus, Ohio.
Given Dawson Paisley Funeral Home has been serving Coshocton area families for over 70 years. I'm Bill Given, and we are honored that so many of you have chosen Given Dawson Paisley. Our membership in Dignity Memorial Network allows us to offer services that no other funeral home can offer. Whether you are planning or in your time of need, Given Dawson Paisley Funeral Home would be honored to serve your family now and in the future.
If you're a business or do-it-yourselfer looking for the best possible siding for your home or office, then stop by MRV Siding Supply. They offer the number one rated panel on the market, Cedar Max Super Polymer Insulated Siding by Provia. Cedar Max provides outstanding performance inside and out with impact resistance, impervious to moisture, flame retardant, and noise reduction, giving you peace of mind. For Cedar Max Super Polymer Insulated Siding by Provia, call MRV Siding Supply at 800-524-7436. Visit them on the web at mrvsiding.com.
The Appearance Supply Glass and Paint, your window tinting specialist for Johnson's Window Tinting for residential and vehicles. Johnson's Window Tints are designed for style, protection, and heat reduction, and they have a lifetime warranty. Remember, Appearance Supply Glass and Paint for auto glass, including windshields, residential, and commercial glass. They also stock PPG Automotive Paint and Supplies. That's Appearance Supply Glass and Paint, 115 Bridge Street, Coshocton. Appearance Supply is proud to sponsor the Woodworker of the Week, a weekly award given to the hardest working Ridgewood General football player.
It's halftime and Ridgewood out in front of Malvern by a score of 14-0. Let's take a quick look at the numbers in the first half. First for Ridgewood in the rushing department. The Generals rushed for 162 yards in the first half. They were led by Colin Smith, who had 72 yards and 11 carries. Carter Fry had 34 yards. Josiah Cahill had 45 yards plus the touchdown. Throwing the football, Carter Fry 4 of 8 for 20 yards. He did have two passes picked off. So total yards for Ridgewood, 182. They had 11 first downs. They had four penalties for 45 yards and, as mentioned, had the two turnovers. For Malvern, they had 18 rushing yards in the first half. They had 24 yards through the air on 2 of 11 throwing the football. So their total offense was 40 yards in total offense. First downs, 3 in the first half. They only had one penalty for 5 yards. Turnovers, they turned the ball over one time on an interception. Now taking a look at the first half defensive numbers, here's Chris Wallace.
Thank you very much, Coos. First taking a look at the Malvern Hornets. Leading the way with 4 tackles is Charles Motes. And with 3 tackles, Kyler Bossert. 2 tackles apiece, Rodney Smith, Ryan Runyon, and Drake Hutchison. And with 1 tackle apiece, Julius Gore, Chance Miller, Manny Walker, KJ Waffler, and Dylan Phillips. Taking a look now for the Ridgewood Generals. Leading the way with 3 tackles is Quincy Haynes. 2 tackles, Logan Sesser. And with 1 tackle apiece, Cohen Parsons, Braylon Williams, Josiah Cahill, Caleb Schrock, Cam Hirschberger, and Jonas Paw. Taking a look at third down conversions, Ridgewood is 3 of 5 in the first half. Malvern is 2 of 6.
All right, let's take a look around the area and some scores that we have here at halftime. Coshocton down at Morgan. Morgan leads at the half 19-0. Also down at, well, Riverview is up on Meadowbrook 25-14 in the first half. Tri-Valley, New Lexington, we expected that to be a good one. New Lexington leading Tri-Valley 12-7. Sheridan's out in front of John Glenn 14-7. West Muskingum and Philo are deadlocked at 14 apiece. And Maysville's out in front of Crooksville 14-0. In the IVC games that we have right now, Sandy Valley leads East Canton 13-7. Indian Valley big over Newcomerstown 35-0. Claymont is out in front of Buckeye Trail by a score of 13-0. And as we speak, that are the only scores that we currently have available. Before we break, I just want to ask Chris, you know, really, is a defensive first half at Ridgewood, kind of their own worst enemy, had opportunities, just couldn't get it in the end zone.
Yeah, certainly so, and a few, you know, unwarranted penalties as well. But, you know, you take a look at the tackles here, and the leading tackle in the first half, Quincy Haynes, only has three tackles, and there's only, you know, a handful of generals with tackles. That just kind of shows how much the generals have been on defense and how many plays have actually resulted in positive yards and a tackle there for Malvern. But, yeah, you know, Ridgewood doing a great job moving the ball, had a few mental mistakes, and it seems kind of like it's been all Ridgewood air in the first half, and it's still only 14-0, so I'm sure they're wanting to tighten some things up there at the half and see if they can come out, again, playing pretty well defensively, not allowing, I think there was until the last drive of Malvern, I think he had said there was negative yards for them offensively, so Ridgewood doing a great job defensively, just needs to kind of run the ball a little bit better and maybe look for the end zone and really cut down on penalties is the biggest thing.
All right, that's halftime, and we should get started here in a little bit. It's 14-0 Ridgewood out in front. We'll break away and be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Think you have to settle for mediocre car insurance to save money? Think again. It's possible to get superior coverage and still save money with Erie Insurance. Customers who switch to Erie saved up to $951. It pays to compare. Switch and save with Erie.
Your local Erie agent in Coshocton is Albertson Lawrence Agency. Get a quote today.
Annual savings based on new customers surveyed in March 2022 who reported savings when switching auto insurance. Individual premiums and savings will vary.
Hi, this is Kyle Hamilton. Over the years, we've been asked a lot of questions, like why is our bank any different than those big city banks? After all, most banks offer the same products and services. The difference is our people and our service. We give you the one-on-one, first-name, friendly service that you deserve. The Home Loan Savings Bank. A better way to bank. Member FDIC.
Buckeye Beverage Barn in West Lafayette has carry-out salads, pizza, calzones, and their new wings. Place your orders at 545-9525. Buckeye Beverage Barn has the area's best selection of cold drinks and hot food with all the convenience of their drive-thru. See them for snacks, bagged ice, salads, and delicious pizza. Order yours tonight at 545-9525. Drive through and see them 7 days a week at the Buckeye Beverage Barn on Main Street in West Lafayette.
We're back, and both teams are hitting the field. We're just about ready to get things started here in the second half. Ridgewood will be kicking to Malvern. So 14-0 our score, and as we mentioned at halftime, it seems like, you know, there's no question that Ridgewood dominated play in that first half, just not able to take advantage of some opportunities down close to the red zone here in the first half. So we'll see how things progress here as we get ready to start here in the second half.
And while we're waiting for that, we'll let you know that Home Loan Savings Bank is proud to sponsor the third quarter of tonight's game. The Home Loan Savings Bank offers a wide range of services, including their totally free 360-degree checking. Call 740-622-0444 to learn more.
All right, the officials have handed the ball off, and Zach Starkey will kick it away. 14-0, getting ready to start half number two. He approaches the football and boots it straight down the middle, bounces a few times, handled, dropped, now picked up at the 15. eludes one tackler and runs into a host of other people. Won't go down. The ball's loose and flags are everywhere. So Ridgewood thinks they have it, and I'm just wondering, well, we'll see what the flags are first.
I can't tell if those are flags or markers.
Well, you may be right about that.
Yeah, there's
two markers came in, so trying to get extra yardage was number 17, Wilfong, and he fumbles the ball, so that's their second turnover. And now Ridgewood has it deep in Malvern territory. Big break for the Generals. Ball sitting at the, well, let's look at it. Looks like it's, we're going to say the 23 for spotting purposes. First and 10. Fry the quarterback. Colin Smith offset. Hands it to Smith inside. Bounce down to the 20-yard line. Colin is
Smith
driven back.
Carry.
So he gets three on the carry. Second down and seven. Ball sitting squarely
Walker
on the 20-yard line.
The
big break to start the second half
second
for Ridgewood.
Six. I believe that was Cohen Parsons that came up with the football on the kickoff.
And Waffler trying to get extra yardage, coughed it up. So with the football is Ridgewood at the 20. Fry's going to keep it himself, breaks a tackle, gets down around a 17-yard line
Fry
before being
keeper.
Brought down. So Fry gets another three as they push it down to the 17.
Charles Motz on the tackle for the Hornets.
So Carter Fry gets three. It's third and four. Ball sitting at the 17-yard line. Carter Fry brings them out. Trips to the right side. Colin Smith offset to the left. Wide receiver to the right. Once again, it's Smith down the middle. He's to the down, close to the 10, is spun
Smith.
Down as he got the first down. Be their 12th of the ball game.
Pick up a 7 yards. That's good for
so
a
Colin
general.
Smith picks up enough for the first down. He keeps his good night alive, 82 yards rushing. Ball sitting, oh, probably going to make it an 11-yard line. So,
Bossard on the tackle last play for the
so they still can get a first down. Just inside the goal line. So first and 10. Fry back to throw. Little bubble screen out front to Cahill. He's at the 5. Spins away from a tackler. Pushes forward. He's into the end zone. Touchdown, Ridgewood. So just a little bubble screen to Josiah Cahill. Cut it up inside to the 5-yard line and took it in for the score for the Ridgewood Generals. You take a look and watch it. They set it up. It's a bubble screen right, and there's Cahill. Breaks a tackle at the 5, and he'll go into the end zone for the score.
I'll tell you, that was great blocking on that bubble screen there. Really was what opened it up for Cahill. Nice run after the catch.
So that will go as an 11-yard touchdown pass from Fry to Cahill, and they'll try to Starkey will try to add the PAT. 20-0, our score. Good spot. Kick is high enough, long enough, and right through. So at 10:15 to play in the third quarter, Ridgewood extends their lead to 21-0. We'll be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Petticord Rice LePage Auction Realty is a full-service auction and real estate company. Whether on-site or online auctions, their auction staff will handle every aspect of your auction, from setup to completion. And for real estate, they will take you through all of the necessary steps of buying or selling your property. They would love the opportunity to serve you. For appointments or free consultations, call 740-622-3111 or visit their website. At Petticord Rice LePage Auction Realty, they don't just list homes, they sell them.
Are you concerned about the economy, interest rates, or current market conditions? For timely information based on award-winning research, call Raymond James Financial Advisor Shane Pyle at 622-3110. Shane can discuss your specific needs and provide you with investment choices that make sense for you. Call Shane Pyle at 622-3110 in Coshocton for an appointment. Raymond James Financial Services, member FINRA SIPC. Life well planned.
For Ridgewood, they started the second half kicking off and a fumble by K.J. Waffler gave Ridgewood excellent field position, and they scored on a short 11-yard touchdown pass from Fry to Cahill. There's a kick down the center of the field, takes a big bounce, skips by the receiver, rolls into the end zone, and that'll be a dead ball, and that'll bring it out to the 20, and that's where – Malvern will start, first and 10.
Flag on the play.
There is a flag. Let's see what we have here.
Like there, kind of here on the near side. Looked like there might have been a little chirping back and forth, but not sure what he saw.
So still discussing it. I mean, it looks like now they're just trying to figure out what yardage it'll be. It's a personal foul on Malvern. So that's going to back them up. That's only their second penalty. So they'll back it up half the distance to the goal line. So things keep getting bad for the Hornets. That'll be a 10-yard mark off, and that'll start first and 10 from the 10. So Malvern now down three scores at 21-0. And not great field position here. Ball resting on their own 10-yard line. Quarterback is Jared Witherow. Now everybody seems to be ready to go. Waiting for the whistle to blow, and there we go. Witherow, the quarterback, gets the snap, hands it inside to Hutchison. Is hit. Got a couple maybe out to the 12-yard line before being thrown back. So he gets two on the play.
Smith and Sparger are.
That's Colin Smith with a big hit for the Generals.
Hutchison has 28 yards rushing today on only five carries. They just haven't had that many opportunities. Ridgewood defensively has really done the job. Second down and 8. Ball out to 12-yard line. Witherow, this quarterback, straight back looking, throws it out in the flat. Ball goes through the little tall, went through the receiver's hands, incomplete.
Pass overthrown. Third down.
Stop by Witt's Frozen Custard of Coshocton every Tuesday, where all scoops, all sizes of custard are half priced. While you're there, check out their selection of frozen custard cakes, or call ahead to have one custom made with your favorite custard flavors.
It'll be a 3rd and 8. Right now, Jared Witherow, the good-looking sophomore quarterback, struggled tonight. Only two of 12 for 24 yards throwing the football. It's 3rd and 8. Another 3rd and long situation. Back to throw. Throws it out in the flat, and once again, it's high and goes incomplete. That'll be a set up a 4th down situation. And really almost have to punt this deep in your own territory. For the most part, Malvern's defense, they've been a little bit tonight, but just haven't really broken. They've given up the 3 scores, but you know, 2 of the scores came after turnovers, and Ridgewood was in excellent field position.
So, yeah, the Malvern defense came out with a little more pep in their step here in the second half.
So here we go. They'll be back to punt. There's a snap. Good snap. Booming kick. They're going to let it hit. Takes a Ridgewood bounce, and it'll be touchdown at the, looks like, the 48-yard line of Malvern. That's where Ridgewood will take over, first and 10. First and 10 at the 48. Ridgewood trying to take control here early in the second half. They lead it 21-0. Carter Fry, the quarterback. Trips to the right side, one to the left. Running back offset to the left. Fry rolling to the right side, has a receiver over his Schrock, breaks a tackle. He's at the 40. He's at the 35, is hit from behind and gets Schrock inside the 30 before being brought down. Just once again, that little screen pass out into the flat. Schrock takes it and moves it all the way down inside the 30. They're going to mark it at the 28, so that's going to be a pickup of 20 on the play.
Charles Motz on the stop for the Hornets.
So the ball's at the 28, first and 10. Clock moving as we approach 9 minutes here in the third quarter. Ridgewood on the move again. Right, puts a man in motion. He's going to keep it himself. Eludes, does a nice job eluding a tackle, but then runs into a host of people. Maybe
Fry on the keeper.
We'll give him two down to the 26 for pickup of two.
Runyon and Walker on the stop for the Hornets.
Makes it a second and eight situation.
Second down nine.
Manny Walker on the stop for the Hornets.
Ball resting inside the 27-yard line. Now we have an Malvern player has an equipment problem, so he'll come out and be replaced. Now looks like we're ready to get things going. Carter Frywedding, officials wind the clock. 8:25 to play here in the third quarter. Fry, the quarterback, hands the ball inside to Sparger. He crosses the 25
Sparger
and gets down to about the 24-yard line. Just a couple on the play. So I bring down a third down situation. Well, we'll get a third and six. Ball sitting at the 24-yard line. Generals out of the huddle, have two receivers right, one left. Trying to get everybody lined up, and play clock still have plenty of time on the play clock. Now they've got everybody on the field. One with a stacked look on the right side. Fry gets the call. Now he's going to run it. No, that's Cahill. He's got it inside the 20 to the 15 to the 10. Just keeps it going and inside
Cahill
the 10.
Cahill on the keeper.
So Josiah Cahill with that speed and quickness. Well, we got a flag. Let's see what it is. Probably illegal shift would be my guess. No, there's going to be a hold on Ridgewood. So Cahill picked up yardage inside the 8.
Holding is
the call.
It
was actually a 16-yard run, but that's going to come back as a flag comes out at the 24, so they'll mark that 10 yards back to the 34. Fifth penalty for the Generals for 55 yards tonight. So the ball goes out back to the 34. And makes things a little more difficult.
Third down 16.
Third and 16, which has been an issue all night for Ridgewood. They've had promising looking drives, but a penalty here and there that put them behind the chains and have just not been able to pick up the necessary yardage. Fry, the quarterback, obvious pass, no. Cahill's again, he's going to run it. Cuts up inside, still on his feet, gets down to about the 25-yard line. Josiah Cahill with great quickness.
Cahill on the keeper.
Yeah, Cahill did a good job. Looked like he was going to turn that up outside and then turned it up inside.
Up a nine,
got a few extra yards.
Down seven.
So moved it down to the 26-yard line. Got eight on the play. Cahill with 53 yards rushing. Scored a couple touchdowns here tonight. So he's had a big night offensively. So it's a fourth down in long seven. Cahill still the quarterback. Colin Smith offset to the right side. Cahill keeps it himself up through the middle. He's going to get the first down, it looks like, as he moves down to about
the
18.
That should be enough for a first down.
And he did. So Josiah Cahill keeps the drive alive, picking up the first down, their 13th.
Locker on the stop.
And they mark it at the 17-yard line. He got 9 yards and the first down.
Cahill does a great job when he comes in at quarterback. You know it's going to be a designed run and always does a great job of with his quickness of finding those holes and getting a few positive yards out of it.
So first down for Ridgewood. Ball at the 17-yard line. Taking a look at where everybody's at. There he goes again. 15. Stays on his feet. Gets down around
the
10.
On the keeper.
Carter Fry.
Now that was Carter Fry in there that time.
Pick up a 7 yards.
So Fry gets seven. So they just keep alternating the quarterbacks. Fry gets seven. Second and three. Ball's at the, we're going to say, the 11-yard line. So he got six. Second down and four. Barger offset to the right side. Fry again runs it up inside. Down inside, he's trying to push to the goal line. Got
Fry
inside
the
five to the three and got the first down. That's eight more.
Pick up a seven.
First down, number 14.
tackled by a host of Hornets on the play.
Ridgewood 216 rushing yards in this football game. They have it at the 3-yard line, first and goal. I would imagine if they found a weakness, I wouldn't be surprised to see Fry take it himself. He does. Cuts it up and gets into the end zone for the touchdown. So Carter Fry from 3 yards out gets his first score of the night. That makes the score 27-0 as they try to add the PAT. Really not much to it, just the quarterback keeper and gets enough yardage to get into the end zone for the score. And Starkey will try to add the PAT.
Ridgewood just switches out quarterbacks and run the same play over and over. About the last six or seven plays were those quarterback keepers and offensive line doing a great job of creating some room.
Like they say, keep using it till they stop it. 27-0 as he tries to add the PAT. Cahill's the holder. Good snap, and we've got flags everywhere. So
like a little
false start on Ridgewood. So they'll mack it up 5 yards. I don't think the lineman got set more than anything else.
Shouldn't be a problem for Starkey.
And mark it back at the 15, so the extra point will be from 25 yards away. Ridgewood with a pair of scores here in the third period. Stretch it out a bit. Good snap. Kick is high. It is long enough and pulled it to the left side again, so no good. So with 5:06 to play in the third, Ridgewood extends their lead to 27-0. We'll be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
It was 70 years ago when CES Credit Union started serving individuals and families with better rates, lower fees, and real value. Many names have changed and disappeared, but CES Credit Union remains, focused on you, for you. We will do the right thing, do it better, and keep it local. CES Credit Union, federally insured by NCUA, Mount Vernon, Delaware, Loudoun, Utica, and now Coshocton. CESCU.com. Welcome to CES Credit Union.
When you are good at something, you'll tell everyone. When you are great at something, they'll tell you. Walter Payton. At Liddy Scrapyard, we have been told how great we are. So for a great scrap recycling experience, visit Liddy Scrap. We have the cleanest scrapyard, best customer service, and great pricing. Liddy Scrap is located at 23820 County Road 621, Coshocton. Feel free to call us anytime at 740-622-6220. Our hours of operation are Monday through Friday, 8 to 4:15, and Saturday, 8 to 11:45. We would also like to wish all the area teams the best of luck this season.
Starkey will be kicking off once again to Malvern. Ridgewood has taken control here in the third quarter. They recovered a fumble on the opening kickoff of the quarter, took it in on a touchdown run and got the ball back again and scored again. So Starkey kicking off, high booming kick, and at the 10-yard line, back 20, 25, backs outside. He's got some speed, cuts it up inside, is out all the way to the 40. A nice return by K.J. Wapner.
Truck on the coverage there on the tackle
and
for the
Malvern
general.
And Malvern will start first and 10, about the 41-yard line. So good return, but it's not been good for the Hornets here in the second
Hornets
half.
Hornets had it first and 10 from the 41-yard line.
Home Loan Savings Bank is proud to sponsor the third quarter of tonight's game. The Home Loan Savings Bank offers a wide range of services, including their totally free 360-degree checking. Call 740-622-0444 to learn more.
Ball at the 41, first and 10 for the Hornets. Witherow, the quarterback, has trips to the right side, one to the left, straight back to throw again. Pressure's on again, now throwing deep down the middle. He has a receiver. He's got it all the way down inside the 20. Nice throw and big play for the Hornets. Coming up with that catch was Rodney Smith, and a big gain all the way down to the 15-yard line.
Yeah, that was a great throw, great catch, and tackled by Matt Humphrey on the play by the Generals.
Pass play good for 44 yards and the first down.
For the Generals.
Humphrey So big completion there, third of the night, their fourth first down. So now there, the Hornets knocking on the door down at the 15. Witherware runs in, and he slips down and back, loses a yard back to the 16. Tried to cut it up inside and lost a yard.
Taylor Cruz on the tackle for the Generals.
So I'll make it a second 11, and now we have a whistle and an official's timeout. We have a
timeout for an injury.
Looks like a Malvern player down, so we'll break away and be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
There's wedding bands, and then there's wedding bands. For the latter, shop at Dean's Jewelry, August 25th through the 27th. Save 20% on our expanded selection of wedding bands during our Wedding Band Expo. Yes, an expanded selection of wedding bands, all at 20% off. Say I do to our Wedding Band Expo, August 25th through the 27th at Dean's Jewelry, Coshocton and Mount Vernon. If you're looking for that musical kind of wedding band, sorry, you're on your own there.
Hi, this is Jamie from Witt's Frozen Custard. Have you had your Witt's fix this season? Each day you can choose from chocolate, vanilla, our daily flavor, or our weekly flavor, with over 20 toppings to choose from. Score a touchdown with your favorite custard flavor or lunch special for $5 or less. While you're here, check out our to-go freezer loaded with quarts, pints, frozen custard cakes, and witties. Witt's Frozen Custard is open Monday through Saturday from 11 to 8, and Sunday, noon to 8.
Second down, 11.
All right, we're back, and a player got up and went off on his under his own power, so it'll be a second down and 11. The ball sitting at the 16-yard line, clock moving, 4:12 to go in the third period. Malvern out. We'll have twin receivers left, one right, and two players initially will want line up in the backfield. Hutchison and Waffler. Straight back to throws. Witherow, he's in trouble. Now trying to escape, and he's going to be, ball's loose. Let's see what they call. It's going to be a sack, I'm pretty sure.
Jonas Ball, came loose. The pressure for the Generals.
So Witherow is thrown down.
Quarterback fumbles the ball out of bounds at the 32-yard line.
So let's see what the officials are talking now. I was going to say, I'm wondering if they're going to say he tried to throw the football.
I tell you, Jonas Paul showed tremendous speed coming off that outside, chasing down the quarterback. Did a great job.
See, the new rule is once you're out of the pocket, you can throw it away under any circumstances, and it won't be a grounding call. So let's see what they do. They're having a discussion. Looks like they're going to say he was sacked and fumbled. So they're going to mark the ball at the 31. They keep moving back. They move it at to the 32. So that's a 16-yard loss for Witherow, the quarterback.
Third down, 27.
So that makes it a third down and forever. Looks like 27. So Ridgewood now in a position maybe to get a stop here.
Yeah, that whole play came from Jonas Paul breaking out that outside and just really had a great pursuit angle on the quarterback.
So out of the cuddle they come. 27-0 to score. Now we've got a stoppage of play.
Timeout, Hornets.
Malvern wants to call timeout, so we'll break away and be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Need a venue for your event? Call the Epicenter. With nearly 1,400 square feet of space, there's plenty of room for you to host your affair. Reserve the Epicenter to celebrate life's greatest moments. The colorful, open concept, conveniently located center will be a wonderful backdrop for your event. From birthday parties, graduations, to baby showers, the Epicenter can handle your event. Need table space for the yellow flag sales? The Epicenter has plenty of room available in the air conditioning. Located at 100 East Main Street in West Lafayette. For more information or to book your event, call 740-502-5288.
That's where we'll start when play resumes. The Warehouse Steak and Stein is proud to sponsor tonight's Player of the Game. Tonight's Player of the Game will receive a gift certificate for a famous Warehouse cheeseburger and order of the legendary onion rings. This is courtesy of Warehouse Steak and Stein in Roscoe Village. So out of the huddle they come, and they're ready to go. 3:21 to play here in the third quarter. 27-0 Ridgewood leading. A third and 27 for the Hornets. Trips to the left side, shifting in the backfield. Is Walker who's checked in. Witherow back to throw, looking over the middle. Now he's going to throw a loft one down. They've well covered. The ball is, I believe, intercepted, and it is. So they tried to throw into double coverage, and nice job by Ridgewood. So Josiah Cahill does it all. He comes up with the INT. That'll be turnover number three for the Hornets, and Ridgewood is held, and they'll have it first and 10.
Yeah, nice job by Josiah Cahill. Malvern throwing in a double coverage, and Poach just waiting on it. It was kind of a fight for which general was going to come up with the interception, and nice job by Josiah Cahill.
So they put the ball down, looks like right at the five-yard line. That's where Ridgewood will start, first and 10. So the Generals get the hold when they needed it. They have the football back. Carter Fry is the quarterback. They think there's somebody that hasn't come onto the field.
I can hear somebody say, we need a left tackle.
And he'll hear about that one. So there'll be a timeout by Ridgewood. So we'll break away and be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Claxon Custom Printing and Promotions is a proud supporter of high school athletics.
Contact Casey Claxon or Judd Bone at claxonprinting.com for printed t-shirts, embroidery, and branded promotional products for your booster club or business.
They can also help your team set up an online fundraising store to sell your team apparel to fans all across the country.
Visit claxonprinting.com or call 740-623-2145.
And both teams are now ready to go. They had to put a few seconds back on the clock.
So
3:10 to play here in the third period. 27-0 Ridgewood leading. They've just got a turnover and have the ball first and 10 on their own 5-yard line. Looks like Fry is the quarterback. Two left, two right. Fry back to throw out of end zone. Little hitch pass. He completes it and dives out close to the yardage needed for the first down. Pass is good for 10 yards.
Fry's pass to Schrock complete for a first
down.
So
Caleb Schrock with the catch. Fry now 7 of 11 for 61 yards. Does have the two interceptions, but they pick up another first down. They're 15th of the ball game.
Rodney Smith on the tackle for Malvern.
First and 10, ball at the 15. Fry throws it again. It's caught again. Eludes one tackler. Tries to get out to the 20. Keeps those feet moving and maybe across to the 21. We'll wait and see where they mark it officially. Once again, just a little hitch pattern.
Fry to Schrock once again.
And Schrock again with another catch.
Has the ball out to the 21-yard line.
So that's going to be 6 yards on the completion. Makes it second and 4. And we've got an official's timeout. And not sure why.
Brings up second down 5.
Be a second down situation. The ball at the 21. Be second down, second and 5. Cahill coming in. He's going to go to the wide receiver spot, so wouldn't be surprised to see a bubble screen here. Let's wait and see. Two receivers right, one left, two left, excuse me. Fry gets it, rolls to his right side, has a receiver. It's caught at the 25, out to the 26, still pushing forward. Just lowered his shoulder, and then Quincy Haynes gets all the way out to the 37-yard line.
24-yard.
Got a flag in the backfield.
Way down back. Let's see, they're going to bring her back. Good completion, good run by Haynes, but all for naught. And probably a hold, I would say, at that position. Penalties have been an issue tonight for the Generals. Holding is the call. And it's
holding against the Generals.
It's at the 16-yard line, so if they mark it off from there, It should move them back to the 8. Let's wait and see. They do, half the distance to the goal line. So they'll mark it at the 8-yard line. So it'll be almost a 2nd and 20. Rolling out, Fry again. Has a man open. Let's see, he got his foot down. Good throw and good catch. Making the catch for the Generals, Grant Lommers. And Lommers is out of bounds at, looks like, the 20-yard line. So they get 12 on the completion.
2nd down 7.
So it makes it a manageable situation now. 2nd down and 7. The ball sitting right at the 20-yard line. 1:54 to play here in the third period. 27-0, Ridgewood in front. Handoff inside, has some running room. Will crosses the 30 and is brought down at about the 32-yard line. Little delayed handoff, and that Sparger moves it out Sparger to the 32. Picks up 12.
Chance Miller on the stop for the
Pick
Hornets.
Up 10 yards, that'll be good for a General.
So first down for the Generals. They're 16th of the ball game, and they've moved it out of the shadow of their goal line. Now have it. They're going to actually mark it at the 31-yard line. 1st and 10. 1:40 and moving here in the third period. Fry the quarterback. Sparger offset to the right side. Two receivers left and right. Gets the snap. Back to throw. Little bubble screen. Once again, Lommers has it at the 40. Crosses it now to about the 44-yard line. It'll be enough for a first down. That's Mason Colvin, excuse me, Mason Colvin
Fry
with that
Colvin
catch.
Complete.
So Colvin gets it out to the 44-yard line. Gets 13 on the completion, just throwing those short patterns right now. Now up to 92 yards throwing. So total offense numbers for
the Generals.
First
and 10 at the 44.
Getting larger and larger. 1st and 10 at the 44. 1:18 and moving here in the third. Fry. Quarterback trips to the left side, handoff Sparger, cuts it back at the midfield stripe. He's a 45-40, breaks through a tackle and all the way to the 35.
Sparger on the carry.
So Sparger finds a little gap, picks up big yardage, and gets the first down. Aiden Sparger.
Rocco Marinucci with the he's a freshman defensive back on the tackle.
22 yards on the pickup. Barger up to 47 yards rushing in the football game. They've just done a nice job moving the ball. And 17 first downs. Clock is still stopped.
1st and 10 at the 34-yard
line. Now it's moving at 1 minute mark. Trips to the left side, one to the right. That's Colvin Wright. In motion across formation. Fry back to the blitz is on. He throws the bubble screen. He's got a man open. He's at the 30. Outside to the 20. He ducks inside and finally wrestled down at about the 17. So Caleb Trock once again gets a reception, put a couple moves on, got good yardage down to the 17-yard line. So 17 yards on the completion.
Gives the Generals first and 10.
DB KJ Waffler on the tackle for the Hornets.
Over 100 yards throwing now, 109. Ball at the 17, 1st and 10, 18 first downs now for Ridgewood. 45 seconds, clock stopped. Ridgewood on the move here. The drive started at their 5-yard line. Rolls to the right side, look at gunning behind, and he's going to be dragged down from behind. Didn't feel him coming from the backside, and Hutchison makes the stop. And Fry's brought down at the 20 for a loss of 3 on the play.
Yeah, had a lot of pressure coming from that backside and could have ended pretty badly, but not too bad of a hit.
19 seconds to go. Wonder if Ridgewood will just let the clock run out here and head to the fourth quarter. Let's wait and see. Don't seem to be in any big hurry.
Coaching staff walking to the other direction of the field, so it looks like it.
So they're going to let the clock expire, and we've played 3 quarters. A good one for the Generals. They lead at 27-0. We'll be back for the fourth quarter. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Bring it. Abner here with the Jeff Drennan's Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Otsego Avenue. Before you know it, the leaves will be changing colors and the cold weather will be bringing on the snow. Brrr! Now is a perfect time to get a four-wheel drive for the upcoming season. Our lot is packed with over 60 pre-owned vehicles, and 40 of them are four-wheel drives. We currently have 0% financing on most Rams in stock for up to 72 months. Don't get left out in the cold. Stop in and see for yourself just how easy it is to get a great deal on your next vehicle right here at Jeff Drennan's Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, or look us up on the web at ChryslerJeepDodgeofKeshocton.com.
Everyone at Reed Family Dental is proud to sponsor this high school sports broadcast. Our goal at Reed Family Dental is to create an environment where patients feel comfortable, know that their concerns are being heard, and trust they're receiving quality care. Our office is located at 229 South 4th Street in Coshocton. To schedule an appointment, please call us at 740-622-5695. Be sure to visit our website at rfdcoshocton.com and follow us on Facebook and Instagram. We hope to see you soon.
Fourth quarter, Ridgewood in front 27-0, and the Generals have the football on the 20-yard line of the Malvern Hornets. Second down and about eight. Fry now ready to go, and so are the Generals. Gets the snap, hand off, trying to pick his way through, has some running room. Not, oh, tripped up from behind. Looked like he might have an opportunity to get some good yardage. And that's Talon Carnes with the ball.
Carnes on the carry.
And he
takes
it down to the 16-yard line for pickup of four.
Third down, nine.
So it brings up a third and nine situation. Clock moving early in the fourth quarter. Ridgewood out comfortably in front, 27-0. Fry, the quarterback, has a host of some new people in. Two receivers left and right. Sparger offset to the left side. Fry, the quarterback, gives the ball to Sparger inside. Has some running room with the 10. Bounces outside of the 5 in the end zone. Touchdown, Aiden Sparger. So Ridgewood, a nice little delayed handoff. Aiden Sparger just bounced
Sparger.
The right side and gets into the left side and gets in for the score. Taking a look at it here, went to the right side, and he cuts back against the grain, just hits the 10 and walks into the end zone for the score, makes it 33-0. Ridgewood out in front as they try to tack on the PAT.
Yeah, nice run as he just picked his way through on the instant replay into the end zone untouched.
33-0, Ridgewood's extended their lead. High snap, ball's down. He hammered it, and it's right through.
Extra point is good.
So with 11:09 to play in the football game, it's now 34-0. Ridgewood will be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Flag.
This is Cheyenne Carroll with Buckeye Career Center. If you are an adult who's looking to upskill, reskill, or gain a new skill in an in-demand career field, Buckeye Career Center is the place for you. Visit BuckeyeCareerCenter.org to learn about our part-time and full-time options to help you discover your passion and prepare for your future. We also offer the Adult Diploma Program, Aspire GED courses, and customized training to meet employer needs. We look forward to showing you why we are Buckeye proud. Again, that's BuckeyeCareerCenter.org.
Coshocton Recycling, located at the intersection of County Road 1A and Bridge Street, has been family-owned and operated since 1985, making them the oldest scrapyard in Coshocton County still in operation. Coshocton Recycling accepts all types of scrap metal, including vehicles. If you're looking to recycle your scrap metal the easy way with the best prices, stop by Coshocton Recycling. They are open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 4:15, or give them a call at 740-622-6276.
OHSAA point differential.
We're back, and it's now 34-0 Ridgewood out in front. It'll be as
at the end of period,
with a 30-point lead or 30-plus point lead. It'll be a continuous clock from this point until Malvern can get the ball and get it under a 30-point limit. So 34-0, and they'll be kicking to the Hornets. We just had offsetting penalties, so nothing will happen. They'll just kick it off from the 40 as per usual. Ridgewood ready to kick off.
Starkey set to kick off for the Generals.
Ridgewood, a good second half. Put 20 points on the board here in the second half and have taken a 34-0 lead. He approaches and kicks it down the middle. It's taken at the 17 to 20. 25 gets across the 30 and is hit and driven back by a host of people. So Malvern will have it first and 10. The ball will be at
Parsons
the 31-yard line.
There for the Generals.
Bradford Financial Group is proud to sponsor tonight's fourth quarter. Bradford Financial Group provides wealth and protection strategies for your financial health. Call them at 740-622-3347 or visit them at 636 Chestnut Street in Coshocton.
Some new people getting in the football game. The clock has started. 10:45 and moving here in the fourth period.
This continuous clock will make this fourth quarter go by pretty quickly.
Witherow still the quarterback. Bends a couple receivers to the left side, one to the right, have dual running backs. Witherow gets it, hands it off. Oh, runs into a host of people as he got across the 31 to the 32-yard line before being brought down. Nice open field tackle. Second down and 9, ball out to the 32.
Parsons and Patterson on the stop for the Generals. Gain of 1, second down 9.
Second down and 9. Malvern out of the huddle. Quarterback, Jared Witherow. Hands it off, speed sweep. Got some running room and kept out the 35 and tripped up as he crosses the 40 to the, well, that might be a little short of the necessary yardage. Let's see where they mark it officially. Going to mark it at the 41, just about a half yard short. Nice 8-yard pickup on the play. Brings up a 3rd and 1.
That was Preston Ator with the tackle for the Generals.
So 3rd and 1 situation. Clock moving, Ridgewood out in front, 34-0. Quarterback gets it, he's going to try to get it himself. He runs into a host of tacklers, but I think he's probably got the first down, and he does. It's their 5th of the ball game. Witherow gets 2. Witherow's been sacked 5 times tonight.
Troyer and Parsons on the stop.
It's been a great job defensively by the
Generals.
Malvern
picked up enough for a first down. You got first
down.
And 10 at the 43-yard line.
First and 10, the ball at the 43. Clock moving, 8:25 to go in the ball game. 20 receivers left, 1 right. Hand off. Trying to pick his way through, across 45, and brought down out of bounds, but clock will continue to move as he's brought down just shy of the 50 at the 49. That was Hutchison, the ball carrier.
At the 49-yard
For all your excavating needs, commercial and residential, call Vic Allen Construction and Excavating at 740-502-0354. Specializing in site work, driveways, demolition, and hauling, call Vic for a free estimate at 502-0354.
Second down and 4, the ball sitting at the 49-yard line. Ridgewood out in front, 34-0. Straight back, Witherow rolls to the left side this time. Pass a run, pass a receiver, and I think Ridgewood came up with the, oh, they're going to say incomplete.
Ooh.
But boy, that was well done by the Generals, but it's they're going to say it was an incomplete pass.
Coverage on the play
by
McQueen.
Well, the official on the far side called it incomplete, but the other official hadn't made a sign. It looked like he wanted to call it interception.
It was a nice job no matter what. He did a great job over there.
Taking a look at that replay. Boy, that sure looks like Ridgewood had an interception.
So it'll be a 3rd down situation now. An incomplete pass still at the 49-yard line. Third down and four. Witherow hands it to Hutchison. He's going to be caught. Now he reverses his field. He got out of trouble. And bad angle, and he's got a gun. He may take this thing down close to the goal line. And he, well, nice job, open field tackle. A bad pursuit angle by one of the generals, and he's able to get to the left side and all the way down to the 29-yard line before being brought down. It was a 20-yard run.
Yeah, turned what looked like was going to be nothing into a nice run.
Hutchison now up to 54 yards in on the ball game. Clock moving with 6:18 to play. First and 10, the ball down at the 29-yard line. First and 10. Witherow hands it inside, has some running room, runs into a host of defenders at about the 26-yard line.
Tackle by the Ridgewood middle.
Got three on the carry. Brings up a second and 7. The Warehouse Steak and Stein is proud to sponsor tonight's Player of the Game. Tonight's Player of the Game will receive a gift certificate for a famous Warehouse cheeseburger and order their legendary onion rings. This is courtesy of Warehouse Steak and Stein in Roscoe Village. 5:25 and moving here in the fourth quarter. 34-0, Ridgewood in front, but Malvern threatening. Ball to 26, hands off inside, trying to bounce outside, has some running room, and slips down as he got down around the 20. Going to say the 22 before he is brought down. So he picked up 4 on the carry.
We'll give Cohen Parsons.
Carnes on the tackle for the Generals.
Or we'll give Carnes credit
third
on the tackle.
Third down 3, ball's at the 22-yard line.
Ball at the 22, third and 3. People moving in and out on both sides. 4:40 and moving here in the fourth quarter. Play clock down to 3 seconds. They may not get this off. They did not. So that'll back them up 5 yards from the 22 to the 27.
Yes, as the clock continues to move.
Delay a game against the Hornets.
Their third penalty in the football game for 20 yards. So third and 8 as we approach 4 minutes to play here in the football game. Out of the huddle. Straight back to throw, looking. Now he lofts it down to the corner, paws through the receiver's hand, incomplete.
Pass incomplete. Fourth down 8.
So brings up a 4th and 8. Ball still at the 27. Only 3 of 16 throwing the football tonight for the Malvern quarterback. 3:30 and moving here in the fourth quarter. Ridgewood goes to 4-1 with this win. Malvern will drop to 4-1 with a loss. With a row on 4th down and 7. Rolls to the left side. He's in trouble. Now he's going to try to escape, and he's got a chance to run. Now he throws a pass over the middle. It's caught, and it'll be enough for the first down. Nice job of extending the play. Reception made, and they get down to the, looks like the 14-yard line.
From Witherow.
So Witherow with a 13-yard completion there.
To Rodney Smith.
So he's thrown for 73 yards, and the being first down number 7 in the ball game. Clock down to 2:38 and moving here in the fourth period. Rapidly played fourth. Witherow hands it on inside, and he got him in the ankle, but he escaped and got down to the 10-yard line. So nice job of picking his way through the defenders. Manny Walker was the ball carrier.
So Eckleberry and Davis on the stop.
Second down situation. Ball is now at the 10. 4-yard pickup. 2 minutes exactly to go in this one. Witherow, the quarterback, has a couple receivers left, one right, two running backs. Witherow's kept himself, stumbled, and they grab a hold of him, and they brought him, bring him down as he got maybe to the 9 yard line for one.
That was Eckleberry again on the tackle for the Generals.
So
brings up a third down situation. 1:30 and moving six. Here in the fourth quarter. Albert out of the huddle, still plenty of time on the play clock, not a lot on the game clock. Third down situation, gets the snap, straight back to throw, looking towards the end zone, and throws it into coverage. He makes a catch, and he come down into play. Let's wait and see. They're going to say no, he was out of bounds. This is one I want to look at.
Yeah.
That looked pretty close.
That did look close, almost looked like he got a foot in there.
Fourth down, six.
So it's be a fourth down play. Now, as you see by the replay, let's see, lofts it towards the end zone.
Ooh.
Oh, it's close,
ooh,
but he might have been on that line there. So it's a fourth down, 40 seconds to play.
Only 34 seconds left in the ball game. Boy, that time expires quickly on that continuous clock.
So trips to the left side, one receiver to the right. Witherow trying to get Malvern on the board, rolls the left side, the blitz is on. They throw it towards the end zone, and it's caught, and it is touchdown, Malvern.
Touchdown, Malvern.
So a crossing pattern, Witherow finds his receiver in the corner of the end zone.
From Witherow to Smith.
And Smith makes the catch, and Malvern averts the shutout by getting that touchdown with 13 seconds on the clock. So a touchdown pass from Witherow of 9 yards. And makes the score now 34-6. And he'll try to tack on the PAT. Good snap. Kick is high enough, long enough, and right through.
Is good.
So with 13 seconds to go, it's now 34-7. We'll be back. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
With American National Life Insurance, you get coverage options that can be tailored to your individual or group needs, including whole life, term life, and universal life insurance. That combined with an agent who is ready to provide knowledgeable personal service for your financial security. Let the John Ainello Insurance Agency be your insurance ally. Call us today at 740-295-9460. American National Insurance Company, Galveston, Texas.
The Fisher Funeral Home in Warsaw is proud to sponsor this event as we support the families and individuals that have trusted us with their business through our four generations of service to the community. As the oldest family-owned and operated funeral home in Coshocton County, we understand the importance of supporting our youth and fostering pride in our community. Please call us anytime at 740-824-3515 for any of your pre-need or at-need funeral counseling needs. You can also visit our website at fisherfuneralhome.com. The Fisher Funeral Home, serving others as we would like to be served since 1937.
We're back, and 13 seconds on the clock, 34-7. Ridgewood out in front. Malvern will be kicking off. Nice drive by Malvern to get some points on the board. And expect the one guy, one Ridgewood player has to understand where he's at, and he didn't. He lined up across the 50. a learning moment. So they'll be a 5 yard penalty and to the 45.
And while we're waiting on that, we'll let you know that Bradford Financial Group is proud to sponsor tonight's fourth quarter. Bradford Financial Group provides wealth and protection strategies for your financial health. Call them at 622-3347 or visit them at 636 Chestnut Street in Coshocton.
Now the ball's been moved up to the 45-yard line. Probably take longer to play this kickoff than it did the whole fourth quarter.
Sure seems like it.
Ready to go. Little squib kick is handled by Ridgewood at the 40-yard line. And they'll have it time to run one more play. Well, it's not a continuous clock, so this game's not over quite yet. They've got to take another snap. It'll be at the 40. Some people getting in for Ridgewood. Trayson Kelly getting in. He's a ninth grader. Opportunity to play here in front of the home fans. And
not quite sure who's supposed to be out there or not.
Getting them lined up is going to be the trick. Now we're ready to go. Victory formation. Taking the knee is Ridgewood, and taking that knee was
Generals 34, Hornets
Carter
7.
Fry, and Ridgewood wins it here tonight by a score of 34-7. We'll be back and tell you about it. This is high school football on WTNS Coshocton.
Keep your vehicle on the road with new tires or mechanical work from Shriver Tire Service. Shriver Tire offers new tires for passenger, truck, and farm vehicles, as well as light mechanical work. Custom wheels are now available, as well as financing. Shriver Tire is now an authorized dealer for Falcon Tires. For more information, stop by 2171 Otsego Avenue or give them a call at 622-6989. Main Street Station in Coshocton offers family-friendly dining, great food, and competitive prices. Stop by Main Street Station for weekly specials like Wing Night on Tuesdays, the famous Shrimp Tacos on Wednesdays, and different weekend specials. Try their artisan grilled cheese and their mainline grilled cheese, the first with a Maryland-style crab cake, the second with lightly seasoned lobster, both grilled with provolone cheese on freshly baked Italian bread. Main Street Station is open for lunch and dinner Tuesday through Saturday. Advanced Spinal Care and Rehabilitation of Coshocton provides personalized health care that makes a difference. If you've been suffering from neck or back pain, chiropractic care is a non-invasive treatment that can help you feel better. Advanced Spinal Care and Rehabilitation is proud to provide patients with advanced physical medicine. This type of rehabilitation is focused on enhancing and restoring the functional abilities of those suffering from physical impairments. To schedule your appointment, call Advanced Spinal Care and Rehabilitation at 291-8100 or stop by 112 Chestnut Street in Coshocton.
When it comes to service, nobody cares more than Village Motors in Millersburg. This is Deke Miller, and I'm proud to say that we have state-of-the-art equipment and factory-trained technicians working on your vehicle when you visit. And we also offer a variety of preventative maintenance programs designed to greatly reduce the cost of your service visits. We are competitive, convenient, and we care. So the next time you need your vehicle service, stop by and see us at Village Motors in Millersburg.
Life is full of uncertainties. What happens to your assets after you pass away shouldn't be one of them. At Raymond James Financial Services, we offer a transfer on death agreement that allows your estate to be held in a brokerage account, so it avoids the probate process and goes directly to your heirs. To find out how to make things easier for your loved ones, call financial advisor Shane Pyle at 622-3110, located in Coshocton. Raymond James Financial Services, member FINRA/SIPC. Life well planned.
There's always time for the drive-thru deal. Because no matter how fast you are at making breakfast, McDonald's is faster.
Pumpkin spice is back for a limited time only. Now you can get any size iced coffee for just $2. Try flavors like French vanilla, sugar-free French vanilla, caramel, and pumpkin spice for a limited time. Only $2.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal.
Lifestyle Home Furnishings in the Downtown or Plaza is your hometown furniture, mattress, and appliance store. Featuring everyday low prices, flexible payment plans, and our Lifestyle Smart Lease with 120 days same as cash, Lifestyle makes it easy and affordable to get the home furnishings you're looking for. Stop by or give us a call. Find us on Facebook or shop online at shoplifestylenow.com. lifestyle. Home furnishings, your life, your style, your home.
It's tough to make time for what matters. That's why CES Credit Union gives you tools like bill pay, mobile deposit capture, digital wallet. It's all here at CES. Oh, and we still enjoy seeing you in person, too. That will never change. Here for Ashland, Coshocton, Delaware, Holmes, Knox, Licking, Morrow, and Richland County. Federally insured by NCUA, CESCU.com. CES Credit Union. Mount Vernon, Coshocton, Delaware, Utica, and Loudonville.
Well, the Ridgewood Generals, after a slow start, took control in the second half and rolled to a 34-7 win here this evening over Malvern. With the win, the Generals improved to 4-1. With the loss, Malvern drops to 4-1 on the campaign. It was an excellent ball game for the Generals, especially on the defensive side, as they managed to make play after play to get this win. The second half highlights are brought to you by Local Team Shop, the number one marketplace for coaches, headquartered in Coshocton, Ohio. Local Team Shop says thank you to all coaches and good luck on another year of competition. Well, it started well for the Ridgewood Generals in the first quarter with 8:23 to go. They scored on this play. There's a snap, handoff, Colin Smith, big hole right up the middle. He just pushes into the end zone, touchdown, Ridgewood. Colin Smith gets the score. They had a two-point conversion as Carter Fry ran it in, and it was now 8-0, Ridgewood in front. With 9:32 in the second quarter, the Generals got on the board with this play. As Sparger in the slot, fakes, keeps it himself again, has running room, a lot of running room, bounces to the outside. He's going to take it to the house. Josiah Cahill scores, touchdown, Ridgewood. So the Generals make it 14-0. They missed the PAT, and that's where we stood at halftime, 14-0. Ridgewood got out on the board quickly in the second half. They recovered a fumble to start the half and scored on this play. Right, back to throw, little bubble screen out front to Cahill. He's at the five, spins away from a tackler, pushes forward. He's into the end zone, touchdown, Ridgewood. So the Generals add the touchdown. The Starkey kicks the point after touchdown. They're on their way as they lead it 21-0. Later on in the quarter, with 5:06 to go in the third quarter, a three-yard run by Carter Fry. They missed the extra point, made it 27-0. 11:09 to play in the fourth quarter. A 17-yard run by Aiden Sparger. They managed to kick the extra point and stretched to 34-0, but 13 seconds to go in the ball game. A 9-yard touchdown pass from Witherton to Baker made the score 34-6. They kicked the extra point 34-7, and that's the way it ended up. We'll be back and get to the numbers in a minute. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Hi, this is Christy from Huebner's Auto Care. Does your vehicle need brakes, shocks, struts, AC work, an oil change, tire rotation, or other mechanical work? If you want honest, quality work at reasonable rates, come to Huebner's Auto Care. You can trust our experienced ASC-certified technicians to always be upfront with you about what repairs you need or you don't need, and to do those repairs right. For reasonable rates and quality work, it's Huebner's Auto Care, 512 Chestnut Street in Coshocton, beside the post office. Call us at 740-622-4587.
Hey, it's me. Well, you from the future. Let's talk budget. Gas prices are going up, you blew your budget buying groceries, and here comes your bill for car insurance. Now, that's one bill you can control when you choose Erie Insurance.
Do your future self a favor and ask about rate lock from Erie.
The only thing going down is the waistline on our jeans. Yep, low rise are back in again. Ugh.
Your local Erie agent in Coshocton is Albertson Lawrence Agency. Get a quote today.
Go to ErieInsurance.com for company licensure and product details.
Coshocton Regional Medical Center is committed to prioritizing the safety of our patients. That promise of better care is reflected in our achievement of a Leapfrog Hospital Safety Grade A for safety excellence and a top 10% ranking for patient safety in the nation from Health Grades 2 years in a row. We strive to be the gold standard of care and have demonstrated that pledge to every patient with our commitment to patient safety. Coshocton Regional Medical Center, where care matters most.
Stop in to Amici's Pizza before or after the game for the area's best in homemade pizza, salads, subs, wings, and more. Amici's Pizza uses handmade dough made fresh every day. For all the flavor but less calories, try their cauliflower crust pizza or other items like spaghetti and meatballs or chicken Alfredo. Amici's Pizza delivers free to West Lafayette and surrounding areas. For big city taste at a small town price, it's Amici's Pizza, 740-545-1923. In life, you get what you pay for, and you always look to save a little extra cash. But when it comes to your car, do you really want to cut corners? Or do you want to make sure, in the event of an accident, you get your vehicle fixed the right way? Brillhart's Body Shop will give you the quality, attention to detail, and satisfaction you deserve when getting your vehicle fixed. Give Brillhart's Body Shop a call at 740-622-0121 or stop by 622 Main Street in Coshocton.
Ohio Means Jobs Coshocton County is the best-kept secret in Coshocton. Come in if you're thinking of switching jobs or moving up in your career and need tuition assistance for training. Come down to the Ohio Means Jobs Coshocton County Job Center in the lower level of Job and Family Services and ask about the Workforce Innovation and Opportunities Act, or WIOA. WIOA is a tuition assistance program that can pay for many aspects of a variety of training programs. You can contact Edward Zinkin at 740-295-7550 for more information.
Pearl Valley Cheese, located right here in Coshocton County, has been making award-winning Swiss cheese since 1928. They also make naturally smoked Swiss, baby Swiss, and Lacy Swiss, along with Colby, Marble, Pepper Jack, Chipotle Pepper Jack, Farmers, Jumping Jack, and Lacy Baby Swiss. When it comes to cheese, nobody does it better than Pearl Valley Cheese. Visit their retail store on State Route 93. They're open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., or Saturday, 9 to 4 p.m.
How many times have you wanted to look at a property and didn't know which realtor to call? You want somebody who's patient, understands your interests, and won't try to sell you something you don't want. Find that person in me, Carla Norris, from the Howard Hanna Real Estate Services Coshocton office. Give me a call today at 740-502-1881.
When you are good at something, you'll tell everyone. When you are great at something, they'll tell you. Walter Payton. At Liddy Scrapyard, we have been told how great we are. So for a great scrap recycling experience, visit Liddy Scrap. We have the cleanest scrapyard, best customer service, and great pricing. Liddy Scrap is located at 23820 County Road 621, Coshocton. Feel free to call us anytime at 740-622-6220. Our hours of operation are Monday through Friday, 8 to 4:15, and Saturday, 8 to 11:45. We would also like to wish all the area teams the best of luck this season.
This is John from the Warehouse Restaurant in Roscoe Village. The Warehouse is again proud to sponsor the Player of the Game, where they will receive our legendary onion rings and our famous cheeseburger. The Warehouse is the place to go before or after the game, or the place to be to watch your favorite college or professional team. The Warehouse is open 7 days a week, 11 to 9 Monday through Thursday, 11 to 10 Friday and Saturday, and 11 to 5 on Sunday. Good luck to all the area high school teams.
9 yards. He had a touchdown pass. Did have two picked off. So Ridgewood with 18 first downs in the game. They had six penalties for 55 yards, and they turned it over the two times. For Malvern, they rushed for 52 yards in the football game. They were 5 of 19 throwing the football with two interceptions for 82 yards. So 134 total yards in the game for Malvern. They had seven first downs, four penalties for 25 yards, and they turned it over three times in the football game. Now with the final team defensive numbers, here's Chris Wallace.
Thank you very much, Coos. Taking a look defensively for the Malvern Hornets, leading the way with six big tackles, Charles Motz. And with four tackles apiece, we had Kyle Bassart. And three tackles each, Drake Hutchison, Manny Walker, and Rodney Smith. And two tackles each was Ryan Runyon and Chance Miller. One tackle apiece. Rocco Marinucci, Julius Gore, and Dylan Phillips. Now taking a look at the Ridgewood Generals. Leading the way with four tackles was Cohen Parsons. And with three tackles each, we had Quincy Haynes. Quincy Haynes only. Two tackles each, Jonas Paul, Logan Sesser, and Caleb Schrock. And also Cannon Eikenberry with one tackle each. Braylon Williams, Matt Humphrey, Josiah Cahill, Colin Smith, Cam Hirschberger, Jace McQueen, Reed Schroyer, and Preston Ator. Taking a look at third down conversions, Ridgewood was 4 of 8, Malvern 5 of 12.
All right, we'll break away for a moment and get back with the player of the game. This is high school football on WTNS, Coshocton.
Coshocton Recycling, located at the intersection of County Road 1A and Bridge Street, has been family-owned and operated since 1985, making them the oldest scrapyard in Coshocton County still in operation. Coshocton Recycling accepts all types of scrap metal, including vehicles. If you're looking to recycle your scrap metal the easy way with the best prices, stop by Coshocton Recycling. They are open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 4:15, or give them a call at 740-622-6276.
If you own a farm, you know that a one-size-fits-all insurance policy isn't a smart way to do business. I'm John Iannello, your American National Insurance agent in Coshocton, Holmes, and surrounding counties. American National can provide you with a flexible farm package that allows you to customize a policy to match your individual needs. Call me at 740-295-9460, because while you know your business, we know how to help insure it.
We're back, and it was a big Ridgewood win here tonight as they improved to 4-1 with that 34-7 win over Malvern. Before we break off for the evening, we wanted to talk to Chris Wallace a little bit about this game tonight. You know, it was a pretty good effort by Ridgewood. It was a little bit of a slow start, but they recovered that fumble right off the get-go in the third quarter, punched it in, and then took off from there.
Yeah, certainly so. And I tell you, good job to Malvern. And that second half, they really came out with a little more pep in their step defensively and really fired off the ball. And other than the kickoff turnover there, they played pretty well defensively there in the second half. But other than the penalties for Ridgewood, Ridgewood played an outstanding game. I mean, you talk about those front four, both offensive and defensively, five for the offensive line. They just played outstanding, really getting a lot of push on that defensive line. And just did a great job. You really got to give it to those guys in the trenches tonight. But Carter Fry had a great game. Josiah Cahill played really well offensively and had an interception. So other than the penalties, I think if you're a Ridgewood general, you're very happy with tonight's performance.
34-7, the final score. Last order of business for us is going to be the Warehouse Steak and Stein player of the game, and it's going to be co-players tonight. It's going to be Carter Fry and Josiah Cahill. They'll be the recipient of a gift certificate, good for a famous Warehouse cheeseburger in order of their legendary onion rings. That's courtesy of Warehouse Steak and Stein in Roscoe Village. I have some people to thank as usual. Claxon Communication had Casey here tonight. Danny Stewart and Brice Lonsinger doing the camera work, and we appreciate that. Katie Holtz back at WTNS Central. I have my partner Chris Wallace. Final score here tonight is Ridgewood, a winner over Malvern by a score of 34-7. I'm Steve Corries. Have a nice night, everyone.
This is John from the Warehouse Restaurant in Roscoe Village. The Warehouse is again proud to sponsor the player of the game, where they will receive our legendary onion rings and our famous cheeseburger. The Warehouse is the place to go before or after the game, or the place to be to watch your favorite college or professional team. The Warehouse is open 7 days a week, 11 to 9 Monday through Thursday, 11 to 10 Friday and Saturday, and 11 to 5 on Sunday. Good luck to all the area high school teams.
Thank you for joining us for this WTNS Sports broadcast. Audio CDs are available by calling WTNS Radio at 740-622-1560. WTNS Coshocton. We are the sports voice of East Central Ohio.
This is John from the Warehouse Restaurant in Roscoe Village. The Warehouse is again proud to sponsor the Player of the Game, where they will receive our legendary onion rings and our famous cheeseburger. The Warehouse is the place to go before or after the game, or the place to be to watch your favorite college or professional team. The Warehouse is open 7 days a week, 11 to 9 Monday through Thursday, 11 to 10 Friday and Saturday, and 11 to 5 on Sunday. Good luck to all the area high school teams.